Welcome back. We are doing all signs, Aries, and Pisces. Keep in mind, if it is not your story, acknowledge and move on, check your other placements. So if you have not been here before, I put this out as an example to explain to you how I do your readings. You get four readings in one. Basically, you'll have fire signs, air signs, water signs, then earth signs. Each one can have any placement of it. So it depends on how well you know the person that you're dealing with, I suppose. Now, if I say the word blockage, I will take the card and flip it. So in this case, you have the King of Pentacles reverse. An example of that would be somebody that's a sloth, lazy, doesn't provide, doesn't follow through, possibly makes excuses that they're possibly feeling like they're not adequate or that you wouldn't be feeling adequate and not to expect for them. Also can be somebody that's out of work constantly and not footing their share in the household. So that's just an example. When I say blockage, I turn the card around and then describe it because there's been some confusion with that. So I just wanted to give you guys that if you have not been here and your sign will always be here and timestamps below. All right, so you guys like the dad story. If you are new, you can stop here and go to your sign if you want the dad story of the day. The dad story of the day is from yesterday. He and my ex-husband, who's very mild-mannered, we are really good friends. We co-parent our kids. Well, they're both adults now, but they don't necessarily act like that. So we have my autistic, almost 26-year-old, and then my going-to-be 23-year-old that works in slow and reverse, but he's actually in college. You got to help us all. So apparently, they started talking about meat because my ex, Greg, was frying out for everybody. And somehow McDonald's came up, and my father insisted, there's no such thing. And my ex-husband, to the second power, tried to explain to him what McDonald's was. You know, the Golden Arches. And he's like, Golden Arches? That's in St. Louis. And I'm like, well, you got to give him a little bit of credit for the fact that he actually had the right idea in mind. But it's like, and there's no such thing as a Big Mac. And I'm like, I think there'd be a few unhappy people if you took their Big Macs away. Just kind of a thought there, Father. I'm trying to think of what the other one was. Oh, holding the remote control in reverse and thinking the TV's going to do something. He also has taken his DVD player out because he's decided that it's not working correctly. So the Wookiee's coming over later today to try to fix. It's not the user, or it's not the DVD player. It is the user that is the problem. But we cannot convince otherwise. So that's the way it goes here. Oh, and Tarot. He had no idea. I'm like, okay, I'm going to go down and start my video. And he was absolutely clueless what the hell I was talking about. I'm like, what have you been watching me do for the last, we've been living together almost 2 years here? You know, when I go play flippy, flippy cards, well, why would you do that? Because it's fun. Well, why would that be fun? And I'm like, oh my God, what do you enjoy doing? Oh my God. Also had a tooth pulled yesterday. Incidentally, so did my ex-husband, and we both had the same damn tooth pulled, and I'm thinking what he had is done a day before mine, and he was whining like all get out, and I'm going, it's just a tooth over creeps. Yeah, until yesterday when I came home and my mouth woke up and all hell broke loose. I'm like, get the baggie out and the ice. It was like, holy crap, upper back molar. Oh, now I remember why it's like, can't we just like lose all of our teeth and have dentures at a certain age? Because this is fucking ridiculous. One at a time, they just start going. And one is due to a medication I'm on. So I feel like I'm getting gypped. Just wanted to share that with you guys as well. So we're going to timestamp here. Well, you know, get a little giggle out of St. Louis and the Golden Arches. And I'm like, they're not even golden, Dad. It's like, now I would like to, you know, take him just so he can see the, like a French fry that's got the big M on it. And that would, of course, be like for Monday or something. I don't know. Whatever. All right. That's what we have for just starting out. Letting you know we're going to timestamp here for Aries. Aries. Okay. Element of quickies. You're dealing with Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. Source. All right. That one can flip out. How this person sees you. How they see you. And their feelings. This is somebody that feels like that you're not ready for anything. Like you still have past resentments, not necessarily with them, but you're not ready for a new beginning. They might feel like you're thinking of them as an unwanted change because you aren't ready for something. And they might be on the, but they feel like you're not interested at all. So they're just going to sit there and stew on it. Really? No more. Yeah, this is somebody that wants there to be a movement between the two of you, but they plan on sitting there with their finger up their nose feeling sorry for themselves. Why? What's the blockage? And it can just be that you aren't ready, because if this person's coming at you as a Page of Wands with the Three of Cups, they seem a little bit rambunctious, wanting to, it's almost like they're trying to use other people being around so that they can kind of get in there and see if you're interested. So let's just get one to see if you're interested. It doesn't look like they don't think you're ready though, so it would have to keep things simple. All right. Your energy says that you feel like there's going to be conflict or too many other suitors here, and you want somebody that's actually going to put the work into it. So there's something about this person that you just don't feel like, or it's like you're really sexy and everything, but I'm not, I don't know where the hell I stand with you. So you got two people that are a little bit confused, but they see you as not ready. They feel like you're kind of giving them the not interested, and they're hoping that things go somewhere between the two of you. If that is an ex, what was the blockage? All right, stingy, happy horse shit. And somebody giving up, okay, because we take the blockage and flip it, like I mentioned. So the Four of Pentacles, when it is reversed, is somebody that needs to be more open. This could have been you dealing with somebody that what just lost, you could have lost interest, they could have lost interest, but it's just like, I give up. I want my freedom. I accept where we're at and not dealing with squat. Bottom of the deck, it does look like you're kind of going, there's better out there. I gotta go. See my ass? Nah, you really can't see the rest. You got a pretty robe on there, don't ya? Don't ya? Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. How this person sees you. Ooh. Ooh, their feelings. Well then. All right, so their action is going to be trying to get to know you, making you feel like they're reliable. It's somebody that wants to take steps to get to know you better. How they see you is romantic. They're hoping that you feel the same way about them. They're curious emotionally. It's like, do you have feelings for me? I kind of have feelings for you, but it's crush vibes. It's early stages. So it's like, I desire you. I feel like you're somebody that is extremely desirable. Let's see what you think of them. You're not so sure. I mean, it does look like you're kind of just waiting for them to make a move. Waiting, I'm waiting, I'm waiting. It's like, I'll give you the opportunity if you cut yourself down off there and act like you're stuck. But there can be a reason that you feel like this person's not completely available. And it can be that you're kind of going, a little bit of delay here. So there can be a reason that this person's not coming at you. So what's the reason? What's the reason? All right. They don't want, okay, when we say what's the reason and it's a blockage, we flip it. So with the Ace of Wands reverse, this person might not think that you're really excited about them or not. Seeing them as an interester, that there isn't any hope that this is going anywhere, that the two of you could be not compatible, especially in the bedroom, but there's a lack of fun here. Lack of fun. It's like the fun police showed up. One more for blockage. The fun police showed up, and this is, okay, this person doesn't think you're interested at all. They're like, I don't think that Aries is ever going to feel the same way about me that I feel about them. So a little bit of a pity party going on here. I don't know what to do about it. I'm just going to sit here and, well, they're trying to get your attention. I think they have feelings that this could go into something very mutual, or they're hoping. For feelings, that's feeling like you could be the one, but their actions is basically taking it very small, because it's like, I'm not sure, are you interested? And the blockage is almost like they think that they don't have a snowball's chance in hell. And it does look like you're kind of going, shit or get off the pot. I'll give you the opportunity, but you got to open up a little bit. All right. If it's an ex, your feelings. All right, Nine of Pentacles. You need to be able to rely on them more. It does look like you would still want attention from this person, but they also could have put you in the eeny, meeny, miny, mo stage where they put you on the back burner. And this can be a person that's like, they're slow. to commit, but certainly willing to play. Not necessarily stay. It's going to cut for your energy. It does look like you're just starting over. It's like, I need something that's actually going to go somewhere. This also can be that this person comes to you with a tangible gift. And you're trying, you're kind of like, F you. I need a break from this crap. I don't really want to talk about this. I thought I was trying to get over you. So starting over. And definitely not going to, it's like your little juggling bullshit game is done. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, and Pisces. Ooh. Person sees you as emotionally mature. They feel, okay, this can be an ex. They feel like the two of you could still work things out, or they feel very comfortable with you and their action. Oh, they're taking action. All right. They feel like they have everything that they need to be able to, ooh, and talking. This person wants to open up communication. Bottom of the deck, this would tell me that you feel like there's a significant amount of feelings that could be involved here, that you would have similar norms and values, and that's like power couple USA. I mean, seriously, it's like, I want to fall in love, I feel drawn towards you, but I'm your energy here at the bottom of the deck, not gonna necessarily, it's like, I ain't gonna show you like I'm desperate, I'm not gonna go out there and just kind of go after you. It's only gonna be if it's reciprocated. So you're trying to use your intuition and trying to figure out if this person's interested. They see you emotionally stable, possibly a little bit mysterious. And your energy, if this is an ex, you owe me an apology, and I'll wait until hell freezes over to get it. You need to act more responsible. So, one more for blockage. If this is somebody from the past. There's a lack of resolution between the two of you. This also could have been that this person was led astray, or that you had a failed attempt at trying again and somebody's still living in the past. But it does look like, I want to try to make things work with you. And I mean, now you have healing. This would also be you having one foot in and one foot out, not being real sure of this person and really standing your ground. It's like, I'm not giving in. You really got to come at me with some better shit, because I have definitely learned my lesson. But if you are absolutely single, whoo, this is like, you're emotionally mature. I'm digging this crap. That could also be going, I see you looking for a responsible person to fall in love with, and I would like to get cozy, definitely cozy with you and see where things can go. But this is like, I'm bringing on the troops. We're going to, what, serenade you outside your bedroom window? Very interested in seeing where things can go. All right, hey. Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn, source. Nine of Wands. So this person sees that you are a little bit guarded. They feel that they still want to spend some time with you. They feel like they would like to see you. But their energy sucks ass. Why the Three of Swords for action? Because they're sitting there feeling sorry for themselves. Oh, ho, ho. Oh. If you're single, this is somebody that might still be feeling hurt from a previous connection. But they see you kind of being the same way. And this could be, this person wants to give me another chance. If that's somebody from the past. If you're single. This person could have already been in a long-term connection or hasn't gotten out of it yet. Don't let them fool you. Don't let them fool you. Look at show at the bottom again. Eight of Cups. This person needs, if you're single, yeah, there's probably a really good reason that you're leery. It's like, that's great that you feel like I'm somebody worth spending time with and everything. But first, you have to get into separation if there's going to be any hope here. It's like, I'm not living in an illusion at all. You need to get the out of Dodge first. Get out. Dump the ex, whatever the case may be. What's holding them back? More for what's holding them back. It's almost like they're just non-negating, non-negotiating, it's like, I don't want to just, it's almost like they're kind of pussyfooting around about making that move. I'm not interested enough yet. I don't quite see leaving just, why don't they see leaving just yet? What the hell are they doing with you then? Satisfied? No. Bitter? Yes. And this can make you feel like, okay, and this person also could think that you're not just that into them, so why in the hell should they leave? What's the likely outcome for singles? Likely outcome. All right. I mean, the sex is always on, but I'll tell you right now, this person can't commit to you, or the two of you would not have the, look what's on the bottom again. Temperance. That's showing up twice now. That's being like, okay, maybe, but you got to get your shit together first. There has to be more balance. A new connection means a new level of trust has to come out. So you're kind of like, I'll be patient. I'll fucking wait until you get your divorce or whatever. All right, sing, if it's an ex, it doesn't look like you guys can agree on anything. And it's just, you see, you don't see giving this person another chance because there's too many red flags. There's something about this person just makes you feel like they hesitate to completely be honest with you. It's like you're holding back, you're feeling withdrawn from this person. It's like, I know you're hiding something, so why? I don't want to see it. I probably don't even want to know what the hell you've been up to. All right. Let's go through the majors. Okay. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Virgo. Libra, Pisces, Gemini. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Pisces, Taurus, Pisces, Cancer, Aquarius, but all signs are in here. All right, Aquarius, I'm sorry, look at that, I just called you guys Aquarius, so it could be a strong Aquarius that you are inquiring about. All right, on we go. Tauruses, if you are dealing with an Aries, Leo, or a Sag, how they see you, all right. So you got the Fool energy up there. How they feel towards you. Come here card. All right. All right, what's their action? Okay, two came out. So this person's a little bit reluctant to ask you out. They see you as somebody that possibly is very single, ready to mingle, but not necessarily if you're going to take a chance in them, or if there's any possibility that you even see them. This person's like, Taurus is all over the place and looking at, you know, it's like a wait and see game to them because they want to see what your interests are. One more for how they see you. Oh, crap, man. They see, they're intimidated. I would say that they're intimidated because this person just doesn't know if they see you as somebody that's very seductive, very single, but very quiet and pulling back and trying to be secretive. They might see you as somebody that's like all exciting, but then when you try to get emotionally too close, like that you kind of go, you know, like, ew, ew. And they're feeling like it's hard to what? They're having such a difficult time trying to get your attention or trying to get some time with you. This person's like, I would like to spend time with you, but you're making it really difficult. Or that schedules kind of collide. And their action, they're still reluctant. They would like to take you out. They would like to do some celebrating and that all good stuff. So how do you see this person? All right. Well, it looks like you're interested in seeing where things could go. But that can be somebody that you just, okay. You don't know that you want to move forward on this. Part of you is kind of like, I don't want to end up the victim to somebody that's just looking for a good screw. It's a likely outcome if single. Just kind of cool your jets a little bit because it does look like you're all restless for no reason. At the bottom of the deck, you got the World. It would be a new chapter, but I mean, are you interested or not? So they definitely feel like you are holding absolutely all of the cards and that everything is up to you. And they're just like, can't you give me an opportunity? Why do you have to make this so fucking difficult? But they are reluctant. They're a little bit reserved. They are kind of restricting any movement. Well, you are too, because it's like, I don't want to end up being just another notch in your damn belt. If it's the ex, what's their damage? Really? That's not a good damage. I don't want to be responsible for you. I don't want to... No, this is somebody that's like, they're a slow poke to put any work into things and know that they can't necessarily meet your expectations. That eight of coin when it's reversed, that somebody that gets emotional ADD and cannot stay on task, possibly makes excuse. Well, I can't do that because... Stop making excuses, person. No reason to make excuses. And Taurus, yeah, they might have high expectations, or they have the expectations that you're going to what? Fucking behave yourself? Heaven forbid we ask you to behave yourself, or that they're pessimistic about putting the work into it. But this is somebody that's like preoccupied about what they can get from you. And it's like, what are you giving? Lazy sloth. What's the likely outcome of an X? Because I'm nosy. What's the likely outcome for an X? Okay, well, that would be all better. Kissy and makey uppy. But right now, it seems like, and this is your energy at the bottom of the deck, you could be a little bit on the moody side, or, you know, crying in your beer because this person and you have not been seeing eye to eye, but there's still a feeling of restlessness going on. There's still that feeling of, I don't want to end up being the victim here. And this can be this person making bullshit excuses, too. It's like, stop with the excuses. Just get with the goddamn programs. Like, I have feelings for you, but I'm also smart enough not to be screwed over. And I feel like you've been letting me down emotionally. Why would I be fucking moody? Oh, lots of reasons. You know, jealousy. Obsessing about this person. Don't get obsessed with what's going on in this person's life. Because that makes you codependent. You don't want to end up being codependent. Wait and see what happens. Because I would say this person's going to reach out, even if they are a little bit of a wimp. Alrighty. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. We have the Nine of Wands. As this person sees you, their feeling. Ooh. And their action. Okay, why are they making it? What's with the fucking bullshit excuses? Okay, well, you got the Devil on that one. So they feel like you want to settle down and that you're being stern and shitty. Ooh, this person sees you as extremely guarded and not tolerating any of their shit. Kind of like if they had walked away, you're going, keep fucking walking then. If you can't follow my rules and you can't get along well with others and be an ass of the class, then you can really kind of piss off. That Five of Swords, when it's reversed, it's like, it's a truce. It's you contradict yourself. You send me mixed signals. I'm biting my tongue. And they just are like, well, shit, man, Taurus is pissed. If it's an X, the blockage. They don't know what the hell they want. Now, this can be that they need to be making a choice between two people, or they're leaving you in the middle of nowhere. What do I do? Well, I'm interested. I'm optimistic. I still feel like this is a sure thing. It does look like you would like to have no blockages and no barriers in the way, but you also want the talk. Where is this going? And you will be, I demand respect. And you might feel like this person was delaying having any kind of major commitment. It's almost like in the back of my mind, I honestly know the truth, and waiting around for the decision, this person getting to act like a big boy or girl, it's all about what? Growth of what's in their pants. Yeah, okay, or a really horny female. But with this Ace of Wands here, it's like there could be something to grow and to, you know, let it move forward. And it's almost like they're going backwards. Well, I know you want this, but again, I feel bullshit excuses. What do you want? You want this person back? You want them to get their shit together? If you're single, how does this go forward? I don't know. I'd be a little bit careful. Because it does look like things are not going to turn out exactly how you would like them to be. Because this person might be doing a little ass kissing and going back home. They're not using, there's no, he's domineering. He is by no stretch of the means anything serious as far as emotions. He's just stern and stable. And if you fit into his stability, so be it. But very confident about possibly going back, even though things hadn't gone so well. Now they want to face the music. Oh boy. Same bullshit toxic patterns. So if you're single, I would be a little bit careful. And it does look like they feel like you want something serious and that you're kind of standoffish, possibly hard to please and making assumptions. Well, I think I would assume too, if their energy says they're going to make up excuses because they're off doing whatever the hell they want. I'm making excuses about my smooth talking happy horse shit. It's just love. I'm just pretending. I'm playing a part to try to get what I want. Sassy, sassy. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. All right. The Lovers. The Three of Swords reversed. All right, they're actually much better. Okay, so how this person sees you. One more. Okay, if you are single, this is somebody that's looking for, now can be a Gemini and just straight up a Gemini, but they see you as somebody that wants something long-term and very comfortable and that has longevity, that you're looking for family, the white picket fence, you know, all the good stuff, and that you want to be satisfied and successful at a getting the one, looking for the one. They feel about you, the Three of Swords reversed. Okay. This is somebody that feels like it's time to, for you to step out of your comfort zone a little bit, because it's like, okay, you've been telling me you're healing for so long, but are you actually going to follow through? Now they're waiting for you to do so, because strength reverse can be, I'm getting a little bit, I feel like you're just not giving me any chance, like you're avoiding any risks with me, and I'm feeling intimidated by this, and I'm kind of getting ants in my pants for you to finally figure out that I'm not going to hurt you. Their action, that's a little bit all talky, no action. Oh, but they plan to. I'm going to say with this Page of Swords reversed, this person's just not feeling like themselves with you, and they're trying to figure you out. Like, they're listening to gossip if it takes that, or they're getting discouraged about what to do with you and this connection. And but this is more singles, keep in mind. And this is somebody that's like, they're going to reach out, they're going to flirt, they're going to try to get your attention. If it's the ex, what's the blockage? Well, their juggling game got crashed down. Isn't that a fucking pity? Because they couldn't make up their mind on what they wanted, and they could have been entertaining more than just one person. That means you. I don't really know what the hell I want, so everything's up in the air. I don't really know what the next step is here for me to take, but hey, you know, I'm kind of unsure, and I'm enjoying other people's company. Asshole. Okay, so how do you see the ex? Five of Pentacles. Oh boy. And the Player card reversed. So you see this person as, you're so vain. You probably think these cards are about you. They're an asshole. They ghost you. They abandon you. They make you feel like you're left in the lurch and that you cannot. They're self-serving. They're a show-off. They give you mixed signals. They get argumentative when you try to tell them how things are going to. What's the likely outcome with the ex? Dun, 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 dun. This is just like, it's enough. This would be you being realistic. It's like, if things don't improve, then I'm standing my high ground. It's like, I will have things be my way. I will be successful, and I will do whatever the hell it takes to have that happen. But this is moving forward, possibly away from them and talking to somebody new. So they could be a little bit on the jealous side here as well, but they're still poking around wanting to know what you're up to. And this would be like, I see that you want better communication. I see that you want the family in the long term, but they don't seem like they want to supply it anytime soon. Jackass. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. How they see you. All right. Moon reverse. And the Three of Coin. Okay, so this person seeing you is possibly allowing them to come back. This is somebody that in their mind, they see you trying to think about this. It's like they see you as, the two of you have baggage between the two of you. They're still pining over you. They feel sad. They feel like you're grieving as well, and that there's definitely a feeling of regret. Why the Moon reversed? All right, they're trying to be optimistic that if the two of you, like, let all the secrets out of the bag, no more holding back, actually confront any hidden feelings and difficult secrets or blockages that need to stop being ignored. And with the Three of Pentacles for outcome, this person means to show you attention. This would be a big apology and saying, I still want to work on this. I'm willing to do what it takes to make this work and act more emotionally responsible. But they might be a little bit, it's like they've got feelings for you, but they're going to hesitate to show you because they want to show you that they mean business. All right. If single, oh, you feel. All right. okay, you got to stay in and wash your fucking hair. You're like, I don't really know if I'm interested in this or not because I don't know where I really stand and I don't want any drama. And if you got other lovers and go knock on their damn door. With the Five of Wands reverse, it's like, I don't feel like playing games with you and I'm not going to be an option. Go do your partying and I'll stay in and be serious. So it does seem like you're kind of giving them the stiff upper lip. And then the outcome, No, I feel like you're holding back from screwing because, I mean, you're kind of going, uh-uh. Four of Pentacles is kind of like, I'm preserving my integrity. I'm holding on to my emotions. I know what you want. It's like you want this new beginning and that's all great, but you got to take me seriously first or I can just sit here and be by myself and I don't have to fucking worry about it. Oy vey. You tell them. All right, let's call it the majors. So we have Aries, Virgo, Pisces, Cancer, Gemini, Leo, Capricorn, Taurus. Wheel of Fortune, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, very heavy of your own energy, and Libra. All right, and then you have air and fire. All right, my Taurans, that's what we have for you, and we go Geminis. If you are dealing with an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. Source, fire signs. All right, Nine of Coins for how they see you. Feelings, oh boy. And action, Seven of Wands. Well, they got a big stick up their ass. What the hell? So they see you as possibly wanting to stay single or not interested in them. Let's get one more for how they see you. Two of Wands. Uh-oh, you might have more than one option. This person feels like you aren't going to give them a chance, so they're acting like an asshole. King of Swords is somebody that's very disciplined with, and they're smart, so they're trying to figure you out, but emotionally they're detached, and they feel like you aren't giving them the time of day. Like, why can't I have an opportunity with you? Oh, you have more suitors than just me? I feel like there's a jealousy issue going on here, and they want to raise a big stink about it. Why the seven? They want an opportunity, and I feel like this person is going to be very stubborn. I will say they might have some resting bitch face going on. Now, this is the person from the past. They see you possibly thinking about something that they have brought up. You know, like, can we try to make things work? And they see you kind of going, right now, I can do my own damn thinking. I don't need help from you to make my decision. I will think about this. It's like I'm not in any hurry. They aren't like an ex. So what's the blockage if it's an ex? They don't want to be an adult. They're a Toys R Us kid. And they put blockages in the way and possibly you caught them talking bullshit to some other people. We're saying blockage. Blockage means we flip. Can't take them seriously. They're fucking lazy. And with the Eight of Wands here reversed, this could have been somebody that you caught them. You didn't see it coming, but that Two of Swords can be like, okay, no, I refuse to be an option. I refuse to deal with your bullshit. I'm not going to be the one that sucks it up here. And no, I'm the heartbreak or the possible rejection and possibly this person deciding between you and another person. You're like, I don't know what the hell to do with this, but I'm not doing anything. You got me feeling confused about the whole shit. If it's somebody single, what is likely outcome? All right, asking you on a date. And if it is the ex, likely outcome. Nine of Swords, one more. Ten of Swords. It's almost like they're afraid of the ending. They're afraid. Their mind's doing 90 miles an hour. This is like, okay, well, you know, ghosts belong in the graveyard. Did they have a point where they told you that this just isn't working and now they're fucking regretting it? Because it's like a little bit too late. And I'm sticking up for... Well, you stick up for whatever the hell you want. with your big stick there. And this is the one that's standing above other people that are basically being attacked. So this person might be getting it in spades from other people and being told, you need to apologize, you need to get your shit together, or Gemini is not going to even give you the time of day. And they ain't liking it, especially with that King of Assholes. All right. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. How they see you, how they feel about you. Okay, why the Queen of Wands for feelings? Page of Coins. Could be an age difference here, but they're definitely, it's almost like they're not as experienced as you, and they could feel like you're getting attention from more than one person. They're going, I will learn how to make you happy. How they see you, we have, oh yeah, very sexual. Four of Wands, they see you as, now if you're single, this is like the life of the party, somebody that enjoys themselves, somebody that could turn into, that you're stable, that you are emotionally somebody that they would be comfortable with. If this is the ex, this is somebody that sees you as still with them and wants to try to reignite the connection. And if you are single, this is somebody that definitely wants your attention. They feel like you are the Adonis or the goddess on the mountaintop, and they do feel like they're a little bit green. No pun intended. But with the World here, this would be single, something that moves forward. And they, with the World, it was like, I want a new chapter. But they are a little bit reluctant. You got two pages here. I just feel like this person's kind of going, do I take this chance or not? Like they're not defensive, but they're kind of like, ugh, uneasy. I don't know if they're interested in me or not. Do I make a move? Like they could be a little bit on the quiet side because the Page of Swords is looking for information on if Gemini is available, and they feel like doing their homework as far as what you do, where you go. Not to the point where stalkerish. I mean, they could get that way, but they still want an opportunity. So if single, let's see what you think of them. Come here, come here, come here. Ooh, two came out. Look at that. Queen of Cups and the Empress. So it does seem like somebody that you feel like you need to be intuitive about. But with the Empress here, it's like, I could see definitely taking the lead. You'd be taking the lead because this person's kind of like green, inexperienced. They need a little bit of a hand to get it. But their intentions are damn. One more for intention. Intentions. Okay. Their intentions are to be a big boy or girl. This is somebody that's like, I want to be able to please you. I want this to move forward. I will put the moves on. I will chase you. And it does look like you're going, smolder the fire just a little bit there. Cool your jets a little bit with your happy love stick. But that's intuition here, and this is intuition here. So you're able to make a good decision based on, yes, I would like to see this connection grow. There's definitely the feeling of you make me feel good about myself, and it's harmony. I mean, this looks really nice. If it's an ex, will you still give me another chance? Possibly talking to friends behind your back to see if they could still get your attention. And I would say that you still have feelings, but you are using your intuition with these two cards here. You shouldn't have to be in charge of this person. If they get a little bit too rambunctious sexually and possibly flirting with other people, it's just like you need to put their fire out a little bit. They need to cool their jets on that because it's not something that the Empress is going to tolerate one bit. And the queen, if you know what I mean, it's like there's feelings here, but can also get very easily jealous and feel jaded. It's like, I have feelings for you, but you got to make it look reciprocated, and I'm drawn to you, but you damn well better make it worth my while. Alrighty, next. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. How they see you. Ooh. How they feel towards you and their actions. Alright, wanting a big change, making a big change so that they give you attention. If you're talking about the ex, they feel like you have fucked them over royally, necessarily, possibly in court, and they feel like they have to live up to the expectation. One more for how they feel, like they're in charge and this and that. Possibly an apology if it's an ex, because this is somebody that's like, their action, Yes, they could just call it done because they're getting attention from other people, but they might be willing to actually change. One more for justice for how they see you. All right. They feel like they finally see you for who you truly are and that you see them for who they truly are. And at the bottom of that, we get the seven of I don't fucking believe a word you're saying. I hope these two little swords kind of land on you. Not specifically any specific points of your body of reference, but there's a need to, it's like you're holding back from this person. Four of coins, you're just saying, I want my freedom and I don't really want to talk to you. So what is the actual blockage? Let's get a little more. The Fool, risky behaviors, and the Five of Coins. We don't like that shot because that basically means that this person decided to take a risk. It didn't go so well. So that makes them immature and sabotaging. Kind of like, I don't really know what I want, so I ghost you and turn you away. And there's an emotional poverty between us, but they're trying to act like a big shit. Possibly, they might be feeling that they should just bury themselves in work, but thinking about an apology or how to be more romantic, or somebody else came in the picture. Is there somebody else in the picture? Reversed, no. Upright, yes. And it's the Seven of Coins. Let's just talk about the Seven of Coins. That's making both parties go, I don't really know. I don't know what to expect. Is this worth it? Pessimistic. I thought it was worth waiting it out. But if they're slowly moving on, it's not worth the wait. It's like I'm itching for a change, but the potential ain't fucking going anywhere. And if this person abandoned you or gave you the feeling of abandonment and ghosted you and decided to go couch surfing on somebody else's couch, done. Paying attention to other people. All right, how does this work out if it's a new person? Wheel of Fortune. Ooh, ooh. That's good luck. And if it's the ex, it's done. Ten of Coins reversed. I'm not comfortable with you. I don't give a shit what the hell you say. I've got a new interest. So this does seem, this person could have been busted with their bullshit. If they're seeing you possibly busting them, going, oh no, no, your lies and bullshit aren't going anywhere. You're habitual with this crap. You can't be honest with nothing. You have bad motives. And no, it's like I'm finding my fucking voice and I'm speaking up about what's right for me. Singles look good. All right. And I don't give a shit if the ex has got an apology or not. Mm-mm. Let's get a cut. No, it's looking like you're looking for new love. I'm looking for new love. That can be renewing, yes, but it does seem more like a new beginning in love is probably a better direction for me to go right now because that justice reverse with how they see you, you don't want to give them the opportunity to fuck up again. No. No, 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 no. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. How they, oh, well, that hair font wanted to come out anyway, so we'll let it. Oh, their feelings are very sexual. I am obsessed with you. All right, if it's the next, they want to do some ass kissing. If it's somebody new, they are afraid of saying the wrong thing, and they might fail. Because, I mean, this is the movement here. It ain't really going anywhere. They might feel like you're kind of in a, that you are single, in a timeout right now where you're just not ready for anything. But, oh, they cannot stop thinking about you. They do see you as somebody that is serious and wanting a long-term connection. And possibly, they see a lot of value in you. But they want to get down and dirty and do the nasty, for damn sure. But they kind of like, ugh, do I reach out or not? If this is the ex, they basically are going, I'm just going to sit here and wait because maybe if I give them a little distance while I'm licking my wounds, we could make amends. So maybe if I just give them a little space, one more for action. Three of Wands. Yeah, they're going to wait it out. So the ex is waiting it out. If it's somebody that you are jiving with, new and single, the Three of Wands would be like, it's like an idea for a future. Can be a physical distance, but it's having the courage to kind of plan something. How do you see this new person if single? Ace of Swords and the Knight of Wands. Well, we like all that. Likely outcome, you have the Star. So it does look like yearning and burning for somebody, but it's a new beginning. It's like, I want to break through. This person's sexy to my ass, and possibly that there needs to be a wait, like a physical move, because the Knight of Wands also can be an actual physical move. But the Star is like, it's like, I'm thinking about you. I'm daydreaming about you. I'm really hoping that there's potential here. It's at a distance first, but I can feel that things are getting closer. I want my expectations fulfilled. And having faith in this person and that Ace of Swords, it's like, this is a new breakthrough. This is talking. It's getting clarity. If the ex, this looks more like you got the truth of a situation with the Knight of Wands, whether they're good looking or not. You could be just working on healing. So let's clarify for X. Three of Swords. No, they're a cheater, chicken beater. And so it does look like you have found out the truth. And cut of the deck, you get the Four of Coins reversed. This isn't worth holding on to anymore. I need to reject your ass because I feel that way. So why shouldn't you? You are off your rocker if you think that I'm opening up to you anymore. Big difference when we go back and forth. Let's do one more for feelings since it is the Devil. Ooh, we do like that though. So I'm very sexually attracted to you, but I'm always going to try to give you the feeling of knowing what to expect from me. That's making promises and keeping them and slow. And if it's the ex, look at this shit. I mean, it's basically kind of like, fuck this shit, I'm out. I'm not dealing with your lies and bullshit anymore. I'm walking. That's the one with the cloak on that's walking away, and all of the cups are like right here. I've done everything that I can do. I can't change the way you are. I'm not even going to bother trying. It's like I'm just going to kind of try to slowly work out of your life and do my healing, because here you're going, I don't want to talk. There's too much tension and they're waiting it out. Well, I'll just bite my tongue. They're obsessed with trying to make this work and getting another opportunity, but it doesn't look like you feel the same way. Devil. All right, let's go through the majors for you, my gemmies. Okay, Seven of Snot. No, bullshit snot. Okay, Aquarius. Capricorn, Taurus. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius. Aries, Libra, Scorpio, Libra again, Taurus again, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, a lot of fire in here. See all those? Boom, 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 boom. Fire, fire, fire. Pants on fire, judgment. Very nice. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius. But all signs are in here. All right, my gemmies, that's what we have for you, and on we go. Cancer is my crabby patties. If you are dealing with an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius, how this person sees you. Ooh. Feelings. Action. Come on. Let's have some action. Maybe a little bit of a candy ass. Okay. So this person, I feel like they're a little bit intimidated by you as far as action. They see you as somebody that they would like to spend time with. They have feelings for you. This is somebody that's like, I want to go for this. But they might feel like you're kind of putting the pressure on. They have to be just so, or that you are protecting yourself. Okay, like you kind of give them the and being a little bit too logic. This person's like, I really want this. And they feel like you're kind of going, you really need to fucking back off and wait until I say so. One more for how they see you with the Six of Pentacles. I mean, they do see you giving them potentially a chance. Ooh. They want to make the moves on you no matter what. This is somebody that's like, as far as their action, they could be using friends to try to find out if you're interested. If this is an ex, they see you as somebody that might still have an opportunity with them. They want to make the move. They feel like the two of you are still supposed to be together. This is somebody that's like, I will be more stable. I will be more this. I will be whatever the hell you want. I'll be loyal. I'll be practical. I'll stick to the program. I won't be a big wimp. I won't be a bitchy asshole. So what was a blockage if an ex? Blockage. All right, two came out. So we take the blockage and we flip it. I give up too easy and I'm a fucking sloth. This is somebody that couldn't meet expectations possibly, but also somebody that could have expected something for nothing. They might have felt like you were smothering them and they were just like, I can't have this. I gotta drop it. One for how you see them. The X, that is. Dun, 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 dun. You don't trust them. You feel, okay, first of all, the communication sucks ass here. If this isn't somebody that was codependent, and there is a feeling of codependency here, they could have been screwing around, betrayal, dishonest, you know, trusty, confusing, lost feelings between the two of you, but you're just kind of like, I don't know. And you might just say, enough. So, yeah. Because they owe you an apology. It's like, if you can apologize, maybe I'll let you talk to me. But this can be you just going, enough of this shit, I'm cutting you out. Let's get a cut. Yeah, look at that. It's almost like, I'm not your energy. Uh-uh. No more petty bullshit. No more petty games. I'm not dealing with it. This is the way shit is now. Now, this also can be that you're investigating, is this person, like you're getting clarity on what they're really up to, okay? So it's like, are you putting me in a position that there's other suitors? Because that ain't going to be tolerated by the... No. So likely outcome of single. Could happen faster than you think. This person could be a little bit on the too quick. And also can be a work connection. But this is somebody that... It's almost, I feel like they need to be reminded to cool their jets a little bit. Because they can get overzealous and just, no, we're going to do this. I'm so excited to meet you. And it's like, whoa, slow down. It does look like you're open to this and you're going to be intuitive. But it's like, okay, it's a crush. We can see where this goes. The Queen of Cups is very, very intuitive and knows what she's getting herself into. But if it's not reciprocated, won't do it. Won't be into it. So it's like, I'm drawn to you. This could possibly go somewhere. If this is the ex... What is the likely outcome? Okay. This is looking like you got this that also came out. So this can be, I love myself more than I can fucking possibly. Look at walking away. I've had enough. I've done everything that I could. You made me feel too much regret about me allowing myself to be bruised by you emotionally. And I need to love myself more. This also can be that you found somebody new and you walked away from them because it wasn't worth the wait for this person to get their shit together. But this is done. And you could have felt very betrayed by this person. And I just feel like you're done with it. And they can be somebody that's like, just go ask. You know, like they get friends involved. Seriously? That's called immature. If you got a question, go right to the horse's mouth if you want a good answer. But, oh, we could still work things out. No, you and your stubborn ass. And they feel like if they came in and made a proposal of honesty and clarity that you should just take it. No, that's not how we play. Be nice with others. All right, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay, the Queen of Swords. Now this person sees you. They're feeling, so they're pouting. Ooh. They're just taking it up the colon here. They're like, I guess we're just done. You're like, yeah, I guess we are. I don't want to hear any more bullshit and excuses from you anymore. You act like you're the fucking victim. Try again. One more for how they see you. All right. They see you, that you're going to make it. Now, we're going to bounce over singles just for a second. Because this is somebody that would take you seriously as far as an option and would like to make plans, but you better take them, you know, you better take my Krabby Patty seriously. Because it's like, I'm extremely confident and they see it. And that could be a little bit intimidating how they feel. Don't you dare fall. Okay. It's almost like they feel like they have to fight for your attention. I'm kind of wondering if it's really going to be worth it. Because with the Nine of Cups reversed, it's like, is this going to get me anywhere? I mean, they're really kind of like, you guys are giving them resting bitch face, and I feel like they're going to end up hurt. Okay. But they're still going to try. Now, they also could be seeing you as somebody that's already been through it. having a hard time walking away from somebody else, or having a hard time not feeling argumentative because of something from the past, and that they could be seeing you as it's time for you to make a choice. But if you're single, that's a go for it. So they're definitely going to try. I know you're hurt, but I still want to try. If it's an ex, let's get a cut. Ooh, we did a double cut. It seems like this is you being like, I'm restless. I need to do something to give myself a change. Your feelings toward the ex. See the backside of my ass? That's about the last scene you're going to have, because I'm starting over. Three of Wands. I'm anxiously awaiting something better. You and I were just a shit show bound to happen, and this just feels like a big bomb went off, and you just let it go. You're like, fine, it's done. It's done. I'm not fighting for this anymore. It's not worth it. All right. One more for the world. No, you're really just, I'm starting over. I'm not taking any risks with you anymore. I'm not doing it. I'm anxiously awaiting something new. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Aries very heavily. But this is like, there's anticipation of better things out there. And you're looking, okay? And in a very serious way, you're kind of telling this person, oh, here's how it is. These are my boundaries. You didn't respect them. And they feel like you're just walking and they're not going to get their way. If this is for singles, this person sees you as kind of leery towards something new. They see you as leery, listening, but leery. It's like plans yet to be made. They see you possibly giving them the opportunity, but and they're going to take it. But this is somebody that they almost feel like, is Cancer really ready or not? I don't want to get hurt, or they've been fucked over before. But this would tell me go for it. In other words, you should go for it. Don't look back. Don't look at this Three of Swords. If somebody screwed you over, it's time to look forward. Because the outcome looks nice. I mean, the Three of... It's waiting for the ships to come in, but doing so in such a free and happy-go-lucky and having the solidarity to be able to take an opportunity with somebody new, and they're very excited, can be at a distance. We'll mention that. All right. As in, they would have to travel to come see you. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Very serious in it. Energy. Very serious. Way too serious. All right, so this person feels like you need to be more open. They might be trying to convince you that they have something to offer, or they might be willing to offer you a gift. How they see you is the Hermit. Why? Okay. Ooh. They feel like if they come knocking, you keep on knocking, but you can't come in. They feel like you are kind of unreachable. That they don't know if you would accept anything. Like you're processing your emotions, but you're being very withdrawn, and you're keeping, not necessarily secrets, but you're hiding how you feel towards this person. This would be an ex. So they're kind of like, do I dare knock? Do I dare knock on Cancer's door? Because, man, they're smart to my ass now. How they feel. Why the King of Swords? All right. They feel like coming in and just saying this, you know, I'm declaring my emotions. You need to drop your guard and we're going to start over. But while they're really, and you're kind of going, fuck that. Fuck that. What's underneath of that? I'm working on something else. I'm turning my back away from you. I'm interested in something else. I want something that's actually going to be someone that's going to be focused on me and no drama and nitpicky bullshit. Blockage if X. All right. Well, this is looking like somebody that decided to do a little bit of reboundy. Not so good. No. See the love wand here? Oh, I got hot to trot over somebody else and I couldn't help myself. But, you know, it was a hidden desire and you didn't find out about it, did ya? Oh, I think so. It's like this person needs to stop being dependent on another person. They don't change. They don't change. They need to learn how to fucking change. Now, if you are single, this is somebody that might be a little leery, yes, knowing that you might possibly want to go back to an ex. So they're seeing you as a bit on the quiet, shy side, possibly reserved, yes. How they feel like it's going to be very difficult to face you but they're so attracted to you that they're kind of like, oh, this attraction. So I gotta try. I have to try. There's chemistry here. Maybe if I flirt and try to be fun. And again, will you drop your guard to give me an opportunity? So, single source. How do you see them? Respect my ass and we'll do just fine. Ooh, look at that. So they would make you feel comfortable. I mean, that's very nice. I like this. The Empress is like, I would like to nurture a connection with you. This could really go somewhere. Can be in a group of people. Doesn't always have to mean that you're gonna settle down and have 16 babies with this person and white picket fence and a little dog. Oh, look, there's two. But it is, you see the white hair here? It's wisdom. It is knowing when you have somebody that would respect you and follow through. So nurturing this connection looks good. If it's the ex, do you want to hear them out? No. Nope. You are resisting trying to not deal with this person. I would say you're trying to get over them because you got your own card here at the bottom of the deck. I am moving forward. I am not looking backwards, and I will run you over with my chariot. I do like to say that one, but it doesn't look like you're interested in this. I don't trust it. It's not even something I would look at in my life moving forward. I need to move forward. You need to flip it this way so that you're ready for this incoming fun energy. But single is looking good. And the ex, this person with this, I want to come back. Yeah, where the hell you been? It's like you would already know because the hermit is smart. It's knowledge. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, source. Okay, so this person sees you as the queen of love. Feelings, feelings. All right. I don't want to be single or feeling a little bit codependent, but there's hope here. So this person's wishing but not doing. One more. No, they're not doing a damn thing. What the hell is that one? Okay, why are the Nine of Pentacles reversed? Okay. Did this person put themselves in a rebound telling somebody else that they were not single? Because I think you have that in mind. The Lover's card is secretly right here. We block off the devil. Block off the devil. And we see the lust and passion. So where's their mind? And you're kind of going, I'm not falling for this anymore. Nope, falling for a banana in the tailpipe. This person could be very smooth talking, but very manipulative. And this is looking like they see you as somebody that they still have feelings for. Possibly put you in a position where you are jealous. One more card, I see you. And not wanting their ass back. Let me get a drink of coffee here. Much better, a little dry. I don't think you're taking any chances with the ex. Let's just say that. They're watching you from afar, wishing, hoping, but I don't feel like you're giving them. It's like, this is not attainable anymore. So they're jealous. Oh, pity, pity. But they basically feel like you're kind of going, I don't trust you anymore. I care about you, but I don't trust you. And they're feeling kind of like, well, I did this shit to myself, but do they are they feeling the repercussions after a rebound? Because why the hell would you want that? Oh, bullshit. You're discarded. No, I'm moving on. Your energy says, please fuck off. I'm not taking your trouble anymore. Go stroke your ego with somebody else. You're not buying it. You're kind of like, you lack any discipline. You're an attention hole. You're superficial. You don't deserve my attention. Singles. Okay. Oh, that could be a match though. Let's just move some of this out of the way because look at this. An emotional match. This is going to be somebody that doesn't just jump in and you're waiting for reciprocation. And this person's going, I think this person's definitely worth it. I've got a little bit of I'm kind of trying to feel them out and see if they are considering me, but willing to wait. Still willing to wait. It's like, I want to see this through. I'm really itching for a change in my life, and I'm evaluating this, and this seems like it's got potential. And this is a power couple. Very strong in emotions and understanding and caring and oof. both upright. This looks nice for singles. The X? No. It looks like you're saying, you rocked the fucking boat. Now I'm going to tip it over for you. You rocked it. I don't feel the same way about you because this was reversed, which makes them the jealous ones, sitting out watching and kind of like too late because it's like, well, I'm going to sit here and watch Cancer heal because I can't attain them anymore. I'm pissed about it. Well, it's too bad. So sad. All right. Majors. Aquarius. I like that. Power couple. Scorpio. You know, I actually read that this is also supposed to be Aries. Huh. I'm like, well, fire, that makes sense to me. Now I don't know what to do about that one. I got to think about it. Scorpio, Libra, Taurus, Virgo, Aries, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius. I mean, I am an Aries. We can be a bit of a fiery boom. Yeah. Firecracker. All right. Aries again. Gemini. But all signs are in there. All right, my crab pates, that's what we have for you. Now we go. Leos. All right, if you're messing around with another Aries, Leo, or Sag. Messing around. How do they see you? Ooh. Feelings towards you. Nice. And action. Ooh, they're going to behave themselves. Okay, so this person sees you. They want to pound sunshine up your ass. This is like, come on over to my house and let's get real. Because the Hierophant is like, I feel like they're going to value you as far as what they're going to do. It's good behavior. I'm going to follow. What are your rules, Leo? I'll follow it. All right. If an ex. Not reliable. So they see you as somebody that's not taking any of their bullshit and basically calling them out, saying, I don't want any more of your fucking excuses. This is somebody that still sees you as the apple of their eye, but that you see very clearly that they've got a bunch of fucking excuses. Feelings. They still feel like the two of you could and should be happy together. One more for their action. They don't know what to do. They don't know what the next steps are. With the Seven of Cups, they're like, I don't know what to do next. I don't know what to do. What's a blockage? If an X. If an X. Ooh. Okay. So, you got, we flipped it. Lies and manipulation and bullshit and petty crap. It's like, I'm not playing your games. Not playing your games. Do not trust you as far as I could throw you. This feels like you're picking back at this person because you don't trust them. Disagreements and arguments and not on the same page. If singles, how does it move forward? Ooh. Emperor. Something stable. And a lot of communication. Person can be at a distance from you, but look at the bottom of the deck. You're like, yep, I'm feeling pretty comfortable with you. And they do make you feel a sense of value about yourself. So it's like, yeah, make me a stable offer and I'm going to check this out. So you're optimistic about where this can go. And the X likely will be dropping their ass. Mm-mm. Because it's like, this is definitely not, oh, I'm going to open up to you and everything is going to be fucking peachy keen. No, they're bullshit and excuses. It's not going to, you're like, I'm done with, no, I don't trust you. Please go the fuck away. No. See how different that can be if it's singles versus the next? Mm-hmm. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. You card. All right. Ten of Cups, this person sees you as long-term. They see you as somebody that they would have emotions for. They feel kind of like you're a little bit iffy on them or checking them out, their actions. I will put the hard work in to make this happen. So singles, this looks like somebody that you could meet at a party or a gathering or through friends and family. I will say that. Ten of Cups is a lots of people around atmosphere, and they feel kind of like, I'm pondering, could this go somewhere? How do you see them? All right, you're ponder too. You're like, this might actually go somewhere. where it goes, you have the Six of Coins. So this is like, let's spend some time together. I'll make time for you. You make time for me. Aha. Working on love, a new beginning, being intuitive, having something to offer, and not just jumping in. And they do see that you've got a little hesitation here, and they're like, I'm willing to put all my eggs in this basket. I want an opportunity. I will work. I will work. They'll work you over, baby. All right, if an X. If an X. Their action. Nah. It's like they try to get your attention all the wrong ways, and they're fucking up. They're fucking it up for everybody. You feel like they need to apologize to you or come at you right. This is kind of like, you need to be more romantic. You need to be more this, that, and the other thing. And this person here, I mean, this is like, we can get over this hurdle together. No, not if you're going to be like that. This just seems like this person either was unfaithful, extremely shallow, or doesn't care how other people feel. And they're just waiting for you to cool down. It's a likely outcome. Are they going to? Ooh, they are. They're going to be talking through friends or kids. If there's kids involved here, they're pushing buttons on kids. I hate that when people stick kids in the middle of shit. But they still, I still have feelings for, and they could be using a friend. We'll say friend because I hate it when people put kids in the middle of it. It's like, I, you know, I want Leo to know that I have feelings for them and I'll be more serious and I'll be more responsible to somebody else. It's like they're using a little bird. One more for outcome with X. Your thoughts. Okay. You might have felt abandoned by this person before. It's like, okay, you always think that you can get what you want, but this time I'm walking away for good. And it doesn't matter if they're good looking, and it doesn't matter if they're getting all the attention in the world or whatever the case may be. With the Eight of Cups here, you're feeling like I've done everything that I could and this just didn't work. So emotionally, I have to move on. Take your cups and stuff them up your ass. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Ooh, this person sees you very seriously. They feel very fun and flirty about you. So they're curious. I have passion for you. They're definitely going for it. Mm-hmm. They're going. It's like, I'm having Leo tonight. All right. Your energy. You're kind of like, that's great and everything, but I got to think about this a little bit. So, singles, you might give this another, you know, go round. But this can be a connection where it's like, I've got other choices too. I have other options. And this person's going, me, me, make it me, make it me. It's like they're obsessed to have an opportunity with you. Like the outcome. It does look like you give them a chance. It's like, I'll give you a chance, but you better have one hell of a strong character. Because I will be testing you. Making sure that you are wise to my ways and would respect me. Now, if this is an ex, what are they really up to for action? One more for action. Want their freedom? Manipulation and bullshit. The actual blockage. They have no intentions of trying to make things work. They put you in third party. Possibly, yeah, you know, a little lovey triangle. Because I didn't want something long term. Or they lied about being in a connection. But this is somebody that's just like, the fire was smoldered. And you're just materialized person. Depleted your bank account. Gold digger type person. And no. No, it's like, I don't want to be with you anymore. You want to have other people and you go. Manipulative asshole. You want your freedom? This person can be very good at turning the problem into you. So do be careful with that, especially with the devil here. It's like their intentions are not good. They want their fucking freedom. What are they taking one stab left at you? I mean, they see you as somebody that wants to be committed. And they should know better, but they're still going to play flirty? No. In this case, it's like, are you taking accountability for your actions? And this can be a connection where you've been on and off. I give you a chance, you fuck it up, and then I hold back. You know, that seems to be their MO or their pattern. They just got to get their shit together. Oh, I just want to show you what's at the bottom of the deck. It just looks like you're disappointed. It's like, I tried. I tried. You disappoint me. You hurt my feelings. Why should I have to live this way? No. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Ooh. The Empress. The Two of Cups reversed. Okay, this person doesn't think you feel the same way about them. They still want to make an offer. If you are single, this is somebody that wants to... It does look like you're holding back a little bit because it's like, I need to know more about you. You would be anxious of being able to trust this person. You could also be dreamy about them. Why the Two of Cups, though, reversed? All right, I don't like this. No. I know you want to have a connection that grows, and I might be willing to offer something, but it's got to be little. Who wants little? No. I'm not talking about in the pants. And the damages for this is for singles now. It seems like they've recently said bye-bye to a long-term connection. So they know you want something serious and they ain't gonna offer it. Nope. What do they really want? Oh, no. That's a fucking run. It's a fucking run. Don't fall for the fucking run. Don't do it. What they want, some nice, hot, passionate sex, and then they're gone. Ghost you. History. No thank you. X, what do they want? They want to feel better and try to heal the connection, but they feel like you don't even want to look at them. I would say you don't. You have the Four of Cups here at the bottom of the deck. It's like, you need to, like, just take your shit elsewhere because I'm not interested in what you're selling. I ain't buying this time. Not buying it. And with the Four, it's kind of like, I don't even want to look you in the eyeball. You see how he's looking down? It's like, no, I'm not interested in this. I'm feeling sorry for myself right now. And you are not part of my world anymore. Disappointment. Cut of the deck. Whoops. You're still not over this person, which makes it harder that they want to come in and try to play and not stay. But it does look like it's not something. It's like if they can't nurture the connection and they know you want to, they see you that way, but they want their freedom? No. Tell them to go home. Wherever their home is, tell them to go. You keep on knocking, but you can't come in. No. Leo. Libra. Capricorn. Keep on knocking, but you can. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius. Aries. Taurus. Leo. Very heavily on the fire. I don't like that. Bye. See ya. After they get what they want. No, thank you. Aries. Libra and Taurus. All right, my Leos, that's what we have for you. And on we go. Virgos, if you are dealing with a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, how do they see my Virgos? King of Cups. Feelings. Ten of Coins. And action. Kind of being a candy ass, though. All right, so this person's a little bit guarded. It's like, I want to take action, but is it just a... It's like, I'm wishing, but am I doing? Night should be like this quick. And so it's like, I have the idea that this person would make me happy, but are they actually going to do anything about it? They could be a little bit stupid with their words. One more for... It's okay. No. No. This person sees you as possibly having other suitors, and that makes them what? Jealous. And then they're kind of like, I'm not tolerating that crap. They got an attitude. They feel the Ten of Coins, but I'm comfortable with you. They feel like you are looking for something long-term. What is their damage, even if single? Five of Swords. They need to learn how to bite their fucking tongue and stop acting like an asshole. And it can be that they need to heal. You know, it's like, let go of the shit from the past. They've got issues from the past, then keep them in the fucking past. Versus go of single. What do you think of this person? Ten of Cups. You're kind of holding back. It's like, I'm interested, and yet at the same time, I'm not sure if I'm going to be opened up. And it can be because of their damn asshole-y attitude. It's like, no, they see you as somebody that they would like to fall in love with, but you have other suitors, so they're what, fucking jealous? Nitpicky horse shit. And this, you see them as potential, definitely. Both of you seeing each other and having feelings of, I would be comfortable in this, but I'm holding back because are you going to be immature? Are you really offering anything? Or are you just looking to play around and have fun? So the two of you need to kind of sit down and have a little talk. And it seems like they're going to make this harder than it actually needs to be. They need to get over the fucking past. Majorly need to get over the past. You're like, can you just settle down? It's like you got the whole fucking foundation set on fire. And it's like, we haven't even started. No, they put their own barriers in the way. There's something with this person. It's like, almost like they get real talky-talky and everything happens really fast. And then they go dead silent. Because, oh yeah, I might get fucked over. Well, really? How the hell do you know if you don't try? The X. How does this move forward with the X? How do you see them? Eight of Wands. Go the fuck away. Please run. Run. And the Lovers. So you feel like they've been behind your back on other shit and flirting with other people. How does that move forward? Nine of Wands. You're going to set the fucking place on fire. You're like, no. Turning my back on you, and I'm moving forward. I'm waiting in anticipation of what? Guardedness and bullshit? No, I'm moving forward. I'm finding who can be a work connection. You got two threes. That is motivation to get off your ass and do something else because somebody's holding back. Singles, it's like it's not much better because they're not ready. So what should they do? Advice. Ace of Coin. Don't wait. Don't wait, because this person's, it's not like, they need to improve their efforts first and have something to offer. If they have nothing to offer, they can wish about you and think of you in dreamy, steamy ways, but there's jealousy involved. What a fucking bullshit with jealousy. And then they would be accusatory. No, accusing. All right, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Wheel of Fortune. Ooh, the Page of Cups. So singles, this is like a timing situation, and they would like to get to know you better and pound maybe some little bit of sunshine up your butt. But they're going to come at you in a very reserved, serious way or through a friend, possibly. Also, if this is an ex, they could come at you through a child. I hate that, but it is there. Because they might feel if they have the children get involved that then things might go better. They want to have a change with you. All right, if single, one more for how they see you. Eight of Coins, definitely worth the while. This one's like, ooh, I want to make this work. I feel like this connection could grow. They don't see anybody but you. It's like, for your eyes only. Your energy says, yeah, I'm digging this. Like, with a shovel, I'm interested. If they take me seriously. So it's like, it's somebody of value to you. You would like to see where things could go. Bottom of the deck, it doesn't look like you'll be disappointed. Ooh, and they're good in the sack. Just saying. But with the Queen of Cups, it's like, I have high expectations. I want this. I want that. I want to feel supported. I want to feel important. I want to be in a connection where the other person nurtures it too. I'm looking for marriage material. Not like you're saying they are marriage material, but I'm looking for marriage material. Here's also looking for marriage material, but sexy and hot. And it's like, I'm looking for something long term. And it does look like they think you are worth a while. They see you as somebody that puts effort into things. So they feel crush. They have a crush on you. So this looks nice. If it's the ex, what's the likely outcome? Ten of Wands and Judgment. This would be a hard decision for you to make, but it does look like you're going to be like, it's too hard to possibly just forgive and forget. This also can be if they put the work into it, because you got Three of Cups at the bottom of the deck. If they put the work into it and prove themselves, you might be willing to give them a second chance. Now, if this is singles. This would be this person going, I really want this opportunity with you. And that would be like, take me out on a date and see what the hell happens. I'll take a chance with you. Ooh. And then the little Knight of Wands is peeking out there. So you're like, let's have some action already. Let you ask me out. Go be in a candy ass. Let's do this. So it does look good either way. You might be willing to forgive and forget. And I mean, either way, you are being viewed as somebody that is definitely worthwhile and kind of going with the flow, waiting for a change, wanting a good outcome. It's like a pivotal point, possibly willing to make the change. So nice energy. We like that. We'll keep it. Okay. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. How they see you. Ooh. How they feel about you. We like that. We like that. And their action. Ooh. We like that. We like that as well. Okay, so this person's seeing you as the gold mine. They basically see you as somebody that's optimistic and not perfect, but they're kind of like, this is a person I could definitely be happy with. I feel like they're content. They don't need to have constant attention. And it's like, they might see you just looking for pleasure, just saying, because it's like, I'm wishing that this would stay in a satisfactory, you know, development. So they're very interested for how they see you. Ace of Cups, new beginning. I want to take a chance. Are they interested in me? Feelings. Two of Wands. This person wants to go for it. They feel like you are the right option. They feel optimistic. They feel fascinated towards you and very sexually attracted. They're going for it. How do you see this person? Singles. Take me out already. Damn it. Take me out. And there's that Knight of Wands. So, I'm sexually attracted to you as well. There could be an age difference here, but it's anticipation. I'm waiting. You asked me out. But it does look like you're willing to take a chance. Like, I'll take a risk with you. I'll jump in and see how this goes. We'll see. Now, if this is the ex, you'd have to think about it. Because the two coins can be a connection that's been on and off and on and off. So what's a likely outcome if an ex? I'm here. Sorry, but I gotta walk. And this person could have ghosted or abandoned you, but it's just like, I regret the way I feel, but I have to be honest with myself. And it doesn't matter if you're trying to come clean with me or not. I know you well enough. It's like, I know you mean well, but this is just not working for me. All right. I'll be out in a moment there, Father Time. Okay. One more. Ha-ha. We'll make them wait. Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. Four of Swords. This person sees you as restless. And they see you as like an onion they would like to peel open. They feel like you're sexy and that you're secretive. Also single. And they're gonna take a chance with justice. It's like, I want to see if we have things in common. Your energy counteracting that's going, yeah, I'll take a chance. I mean, both of those cards are balanced. And again, your energy is the Swords. It's like, I want to investigate this. I want to see them, you know, see if there's somebody that's honest. It's like, I would appreciate directness. And let's have a good talk and see how this goes. Thinking about them constantly, taking it slow. I would feel like this person's like, oh my God, they're very sexually interested in you. They see you as... It's like, I gotta make a move now. Yep. Yep, they want to make a move. Okay, this is the X. Strength. You're gonna hold back and make them come to you big time. Because you got the Hermit at the bottom of the deck. It's like, I figured this shit out. Eight of Swords. I'm not moving. I'm the fucking victim here. You put me in this timeout bullshit. Ooh, and then the cut of the deck. You're being stubborn. Good for you. It's a likely outcome. Worry. Why should you have to be worried if you're trying to make things work with this person? One more for their feelings. Because you're not sure where the hell they're at. It's like, do you want your freedom or not? This would be single. This would be single. This would be like, bye-bye, I gotta move on. So are you trying to heal because you know the truth about this person and holding back? What was the blockage? All right, they think that they can come and go at will. And then the Knight of Coins. We take that and we reverse it. I wasn't satisfied, so I walked away. And that means they make excuses for this not going anywhere. And they're full of crap. And you never know what to expect from them. And as you continue to know this person more, it's like, I expect you to walk away again. Why in the hell would I bother? All right, let's go through the majors. It's like, they're early. I have 4 minutes. I will sit here and talk to Virgos for 4 minutes. Yes, I will. Well, maybe not, but, you know. All right. Majors, here we go. Libra, Taurus. Leo, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius. Taurus, heavily. Gemini. Aquarius. Sagittarius, Libra, Leo, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Pisces, and Cancer. All right, my Virgos, that's what we have for you. And on we go.
Libra.
Wookie wanted to get that in first. If you are dealing with an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, okay. How this person sees you came flying right out. Six of coins. How they feel. And action. One more for feeling. Feeling. All right. This person thinks that they think that they want another opportunity with you, or they're willing to get more time with you, and that it would make them happy. So they see you as somebody that would be satisfying. Please give me an opportunity. I would like to spend time with you. Their actual feelings, though, we got the Four of Pentacles reversed. Why the Four of Pentacles reversed? Seven of Swords. Okay. Now, this person could feel like they need to come clean with you, like there's been some lies and bullshit and you got all uptight. And they're hoping that you kind of drop the bullshit. It also could be somebody that felt like you were being possessive or selfish or whatever the case. But this is like, why did you lose interest? Why did you let go? Am I supposed to just accept where things where they are? And it's like this person lacks the confidence, but they feel like you would make them happy. But first, they got to come clean with you. So they're sitting there with their finger up their nose. And it's going to end up making them lose out. How do you see this person? Ooh. Little S&M going on there, guys? Okay, you see them as somebody you're not tolerating any of their bullshit as far as, like, they're the victim. You're kind of going, not happening. Not now, not never. So what's the blockage? All right. A choice was made, and you came to a verdict. No more lies, no more bullshit, no more crap. I don't want to deal with somebody that I can't trust. It's like, this isn't even going to work. So it's like there's no balance. This person, you're feeling like they need to be punished. There could have been a mutual blame game going on between the two of you. But this is like habitual bullshit and bitterness and emotional cold and needing to face the consequences but not doing so. And it's looking like you've already made up your mind that this person's always playing the victim. And you're not, I'm not taking it anymore. Not going to stand for it. They could have been lying to you, and they need to come clean about something else as well. It's, no, we're not really getting the indication of what, unless there was a third party, which there could have been. Let's see what you feel moving forward. How do you feel? Piss off. You don't trust this person with that. With the Knight reverse, it's like this person's disappointed you. You're losing emotion. You're bored with the bullshit. You're like, yeah, you know what? If I'm jealous, it's because you gave me reason to feel that way. So you're not reciprocating this person's feelings at all. It's like this is taking a negative turn, and I'm not dealing. You're looking forward. Now, if you are single, this is somebody that might want to get loose with you, confess their emotions to you, because they feel like this is something that would possibly take off, but they might be in a connection already. Don't be like thinking that this person's going to be putting you in a third party. What do they really want from Libra? What do they want? All right. Giddy up and go. In the sack. They want your attention. But they're still healing. I wouldn't necessarily trust this person. It does look like romantically you would be curious about this person. And look at the age difference. Possibility. Page of Cups and the Queen of Wands. It's like, okay, you're messaging me. You're giving me all this attention. But are you paying attention to other people? I don't feel like there's any trust going on here. Even if it is somebody single. But you stroke my boat. No, I don't want to stroke your boat. Row, row, row your boat elsewhere. It doesn't look like you're interested in tolerating any crap from whoever the hell you got going on. Heavy Libra in here. But this is like, I'm not tolerating your shit anymore. And if you poke at me, I'll beat the hell out of you with my stick. But it would make me happy if you'd give me the opportunity to try to make things even. I don't think so. Not right now. At least with your energy right now, you're basically calling out. It's like, stop playing the fucking victim. And if it's somebody new, there's too much freedom as far as you're concerned. And too much potential of other suitors that this person's looking at. So I don't feel like you're taking a chance. Not right now. Something would have to change. And it could be that they're a bit on the pushy side. All right. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay. This person sees you as somebody that is a good time. I'll definitely say that. They're feeling all a little bit on the wound up side. This is somebody, though, that they're not feeling like now is the time to settle down. They're not feeling that you might not even be interested. This person's kind of like, I'm not settling down anytime soon. I kind of want my freedom. Or they aren't actually available if you are single. This also could be the ex. And they're worried that you won't take them back. If it's an ex. If it's somebody that is coming your direction. That you look like the party girl or the party boy. Party stops here. What the hell? And they know you want to be valued. And their intention. Not bad for intention. But they are kind of like, am I going to be able to be comfortable? Well, if they feel like you possibly aren't ready to settle down, that also can be an issue. How do you see this person if you're single? All right. You have the feeling that they're just looking for screwing. It's like, you know, you're up to no good. I don't really trust your ass. It's like this person could be very persuasive and definitely get their way, but it's almost like they're on a fast track to getting lucky and trying to settle down. Because, I mean, that's basically seeing you as somebody that could be long-term and be valued. I just think that their feelings are all fucked up. It's like they got the wrong idea. And, you know, they're all worried about you saying, I'm not interested or I'm not digging you. And it does look like you're interested, but you want to make sure that they're not full of toxic bullshit. Likely outcome if single. One more. Likely outcome. Okay. So that page did come up. Messaging. Flirting. Just starting to get your feet wet. So don't necessarily trust this person, but possibly work into it because it does look good for singles. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. The Magician. The Knight of Pentacles. We like this so far. All right. And you got the 10 that wants to come out with that. So we're going to take it. All right. So this person sees you as somebody that's very capable, possibly putting the moves on them, possibly wanting long term. They see you as somebody that is down to earth, that's not high maintenance. They see you as somebody that has high expectations, but not high maintenance. Kind of like you don't have to have Versace, blah, blah, blah. You're like, you know, Walmart. Works just fine. How they feel about you, they want to take things slow. They do feel like there's a sense of trusting you. All right. And they feel like it's good luck having met you. This person wants to take the chance at a new cycle. So it's like they're listening to their intuition and they're wanting to take it slow, but it's like, I want to get to know you. I want to kind of know what to expect from you. And their actions would speak louder than words. Now, this also, for singles, can mean that you meet this person at a work function or in groups of people. The Ten of Cups and the Ten of Pentacles make me feel like there are more than one person. This is somebody that would want to nurture a connection. Not that they're a woman, no. But definitely wanting to nurture the connection. And they see you as somebody that is very capable, and they desire to have what you have, or to desire something long term. If it's the X, what's the blockage? All right. All talk, no action. This seems like somebody that not necessarily broke promises, but they never kept their word. It's like, I say I'm going to do this, and then I don't. And you can't even give them the benefit of the doubt, because there's something about this person that could be shitty behavior. And they I'm going to do this, and then they don't do it. It's somebody that it's disagreements about where things were going. It's disagreements about making excuses, not following through. And it's looking like you kind of had enough of this shit. Your feelings. Four of Wands. When it comes reversed. You're acting, well, I'm not going to say that. You're feeling about this person that they have disappointed you. They could have put you in the position of being jealous, but you're emotionally closed off, bitter right now. It's like, I'm heartbroken. I need to distance myself. You've got me feeling depressed. It also can be that you don't think this person's over their ex and that they're codependent. What's the likely outcome? All's well that ends well. But I don't feel like it's with you guys. I really don't. Let's see what we have for your energy at the bottom of the deck. No. It's like, this is done. I don't know what to do. They treated me like an option, possibly. They also might, you don't know what the next steps are since you've had an ending with this person. But, oh, shit, show. This is like the rug was completely pulled under. I mean, look at the confusion. It's like, I don't understand what the hell happened here. This person seems to have, like, dropped the ball. Cut of the deck. You have the High Priestess reversed. So what came out about this person and they don't want to be confronted? You got some major red flags going on with this person as far as trusting them. And did they go back to somebody else? I'm moving away from the troubles. I'm going back to make things all better with somebody. Well, it's not you, because they're being an ass and not giving you any. You don't know what to expect from them. They can't keep their promises. They make up bullshit excuses. And this can be that this person's going back home to mommy or daddy. The Queen of Cups when reversed is very indicative to my way of thinking of an ex. It's like, I still have feelings for this person. Yeah, they're going back to somebody else. And this would tell me that you don't feel like the shit is working between the two of you anyway. I'm not interested in your nerdy ass, and you just don't know how the hell to get it. You feel like they've been dishonest with you? Definitely dishonest. But I'll tell you, outcome would say this person's going back home to whoever they have been with prior to you. Jerk. Okay. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Okay. Eight of Wands.
Libra.
Ace of Swords. Uh-oh, and the High Priestess reversed. Okay, so there's something about this person as far as their action. They're making it very difficult to get to know them. Why? They're going to just keep you hanging there. That's happy horse shit. Why the Eight of Wands for how they see you? Okay, this is somebody that feels like you're still carrying baggage from a previous connection. And they feel like your attention's where? I just feel like this person's thinking there's red flags here. Libra's not being completely honest with me. They make it really difficult for me to get to know them. So they're just sitting there going, is this happening or not? It's almost like they're kind of putting the blame, not necessarily blame, but putting it on you. That it's like they're trying to get your attention and you're like delaying or holding back and they're waiting around for a decision. It's like, what do they want? They want, no. Now, if this is your ex, they're not changing. They don't feel like the two of you are done. They want to come back and apologize. They want to come back and apologize. So they see you, what, open to it? Do you want this person back in your life? No. No. No, you're like, you know what, you left me stranded and in the fucking dark about everything, and I can't trust your ass. With the moon here, too much anxiety. It's like there's too many things that I don't know, too many illusions of what things had been, and I perceive this as somebody that had abandoned you or took off and like completely just ghosted, didn't let you know what they were doing, who they were with, anything. Yeah. What's the likely outcome if it's an ex? One more. Can you still resolve this? Because it still looks like somebody walking away. Get the Five of Swords. That is called bitter resentment. This can be that you're trying to heal after an argument with this person. And it also can be that they're going to fight for you and try anyway. And it just seems like the cycle is going to repeat itself and you're irritated and pissy about it. It's like, I don't want to repeat this shit. Now I'm sensitive to even the idea of being rejected. And I feel like this person had possibly made you feel like they were bossy, but they also could have made you feel like they attacked you and apprehensive and then jealous. And no, this person might, it's like they almost like and get off the idea on making you submissive and being in charge and blah. Singles. No. Because this person's still thinking about going back and forth and back and forth. Are they ready for something new or not? Because it's looking like if you're being honest with yourself, you would like this to work out. But they need to actually put the work into it instead of dwelling on the past. And this feels like this person's dwelling on the past. I mean, because with the... You're making this difficult. No, I think you're making it difficult for Libra to know whether the hell you have good intentions or not. They feel like, yeah, let's do this, but is that all it is? Because it can be they think that you're easy, and that's bullshit. No, not the best of intentions there. Okay, let's call out the majors. Libra, Taurus, Sagittarius.
Be a judgy fucker, Libra.
Oh, I don't think they have to. Whoever they're dealing with is making it very easy. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius.
That's what I'm saying.
Capricorn. Cancer, Taurus. Libra, very heavily got your own card.
Libra.
Leo. God help you.
Damn kitties.
Aquarius, Scorpio. I also heard that this was also supposed to be Aries, and I'm like, well, I see the fire, so it makes sense. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Pisces, very heavily, and Cancer. All right, my Libras, that's what we have for you, and on we go. Scorpio, if you are dealing with an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius. Ooh. Okay. One more for action. Okay. Oh, that ain't so bad. All right, so this person sees you as somebody that they're interested in dating or wanting back. And if you are wanting this person back, they are worried about the fact that you might, like they feel like you're not going to give them another opportunity. Their action is reaching out in a gesture of an apology or I miss you or hey something, because this can be messages. So I want to message you. I want to talk to you. If it's somebody new. Oh, they're stepping it up. So it's like, hey, let's go out. Let's see how we generate heat together. Let's see if you're interested. Single source. Are they interested? Oh, I'd say you are. Very nice. Okay, so what else decided to flop out? This is somebody that you would be comfortable with taking your time, not in a hurry, but it's like, I would like to see this work. I'm focused on this person, so you got to be a little bit sexually interested. And this is like a new balance. It's like, I would like to be able to trust you. I would like to see this go somewhere. Nice. What is the blockage if it's an ex? Six of Cups. Okay, this person might be dwelling and comparing, because for a blockage, the Six of Cups would be like they're dwelling on the past or a past relationship this person had or everything that's gone wrong in the connection with you, but they're not thinking straight. The Six of Cups is all nostalgic and things used to be this way and what, your fucking waistline isn't the same? But they still are, it's like a timing thing. The two of us can try to work things out, but I'm afraid that you might not want to, so they're keeping it small. Singles look good. This person's like, I don't know if they're interested. I'm all wound up and worried. They're afraid of asking you out. They're afraid that you might not, you know, take their cup and say, woohoo, let's give this a shot. And it does look like you would possibly be interested, really interested. But what is the outcome for X? What is the outcome? Like the outcome. Three of Wands. Don't wait. Don't wait for this person because it would go nowhere. So if they tell you, no, I'm going to do this and I'm going to do that, that's futuristic. They aren't going to do it. So if you wait it out, what's going to happen? A big fat nothing. They're not changing. It's still not a good investment. They need to make improvements on their efforts. Their efforts suck ass. And this is... ugh. I want to know how you feel about that person. How do you feel about that person? Okay. So you got the Nine of Cups. Well, would you be happy with this person, but still a little bit agitated by them? Because the Knight of Swords, it's like, why? It's like you have the idea that this person is expecting to be happy just right off the bat, and it's kind of not sitting well with you. You could be thinking that they were in a rebound. You could be thinking that they're trying to push that tower back up and make everything all better. It doesn't work that way. And this would be kind of like, I don't want to dance around the subject anymore. We need to deal with the baggage so that we can move into clearer water. So they got to put more work into it. They can't just be like, oh, you are my sunshine. We're not singing. We're not going to hold hands and sing fucking Kumbaya either. All right. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, Source. Page of Coins. Oops, a little too far. The Fool. And the Two of Coins. All right. Why the Page of Coins for how this person sees you? King of Cups. All right. So this person feels like there's still something between the two of you, but that the bullshit and games have got to stop. Whether they're your bullshit and games or theirs, they feel like there's been drama between the two of you and they're kind of tired of it. It can be this person wants to try to make things even, but in a good way. It's like, I would like to try to make the, it's like, is it worth the time? Because if they challenge you, you might be like, party's over. So they feel like we could still start again. We could do this. We could do that. Now, if you are single, this can be somebody that's going, I want a fresh start. And I'm not putting you in any position of being in third party crap. I have made up my mind that I would like to take an opportunity with you. But they're kind of going back and forth about it. And, you know, for how they see you, that you might be friend zoning their ass and they're trying to figure out if this is some, you know, are you going to have feelings with them or are you going to friend zone them? So going back and forth, nonetheless, singles. Woo! I would say that they want to take a chance, but they're waiting for it to be reciprocated. Small drink of coffee. Look at this. I mean, as far as they're concerned, the two of you would make a good couple. How do you feel about this new person? New. Okay. So, you're still not over something else that's led you to be trying to heal, but a little bitter yet. It's like, I'm interested, but it's got to go at my pace. With death reversed here, it's almost like you're afraid of a change because you're kind of clinging to the past and maybe afraid of commitments altogether and really just not necessarily trusting this person but not trusting any person. Movement forward, likely outcome. Seven of Wands. So you're going to put up a big stink with this person and you're going to be kind of like emotionally cold. It's just like you're not ready and this person's like, but. I just don't feel like, Queen of Swords, you're emotionally going, dude or dudette, hear me closely. I'm defending my heart. I'm not taking any crap. I wasn't looking for anything. And this whole idea, it's like, don't, don't challenge me. You're going to have to put a lot more work into this because you're sticking up for it. It's like I'm taking the high ground here. You're being defensive. No matter what, you're being defensive. And you see them as possibly still healing. There's a difference between opinions here. I don't think you care. Six of Wands reversed. It's like, I'm not stroking your ego. I'm not putting any work into it. You basically are giving this person a one-way ticket to go the fuck away. It's like, this person could make you feel like you're being led on. There's something you do not trust about this person. And if it's the ex, likely outcome. All right. It's just looking like you're not interested in arguing. I'm not going to do it. Four of Cups is the person under the tree, sitting there with her arms crossed, not interested, spilt milk, not dealing with it. And with the Five of Swords, it's like, I'm walking away. I'm not interested in giving this another opportunity. Four of Cups, I do not want to deal with the same shit that I have in the past. So you're kind of licking your wounds going, it's gone shitty in the past. Why would that change now? This is kind of like bitter. I don't want to, not happening. Not changing your mind. Not right now. And it's like, if I have to just walk away while you're fucking talking, I will. But I mean, this is like bitter, piss off energy. And you're not tolerating nothing. And if you're single and this person comes at you, there's just something about this person that you are not digging at all. And it can be that you think that they have more than one opportunity, because that Two of Pentacles can be more than one person. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. King of Wands. Ace of Cups. Very nice. And the Chariot. This person wants to go for it. If single, how they see you. One more. So they see you as somebody that is also single. It's being basically, I'm available. You look good. You're smelling good. I feel like we could take up a new connection. And then you got the Chariot. That's a lot of determination to try to get your attention. So they're not 100% sure that you're necessarily going to be interested. What do you think of this person? All right, you got the Page of Wands and the Hermit. So they could be a little on the quiet side, or there could be an age difference here. Definitely could be an age difference. And it can be somebody that knows when to be flirty and fun and knows when to be serious. It's a likely outcome of single. Okay, well, you got the Queen of Wands and the Devil. So I do feel like you're going to be sexually coerced into giving this person kind of what they want, but at the same time getting what you desire as well. And what that is, look, bottom, I'm going to give you the opportunity to stand upright, and if you fail, fuck you, I'm gone, but I will spend time with you. We'll see where it goes from here. If this is the ex, they are kind of hemming and hawing about what to do. Are you trying to get over them? Because they would be thinking a little bit, mulling it over. Do I even reach out? I want you to expect something of this. But they might be seeing you as somebody that just wants to, you know, it's like, that's great that you're, you know, thinking that I'm good looking and all that. But, and they think that you're a really good couple together and all that good shit. And you're kind of going, I've taken some time to think about it, and the maturity level is different between the two of us. So with the Queen of Wands, things go her way, and it's like, I have other options, and I'm going to check them out. So kind of iffy energy. What's the likely outcome with the X? Eight of Swords. It's not going anywhere right now. It just looks like you are holding back, or that you don't trust this person. It's kind of like, I'm holding back because you're full of shit. This was not something I expected, and I don't want to talk to you. I don't trust you right now. I'm avoiding any kind of confrontation, and I'm holding back. I don't want to move. I don't see it ever happening again. Ooh. So, yeah, staying to yourself, this person here with their energy as far as what they want to do, they're still kind of pessimistic about trying to move things forward too, even though they want to try and start over with the Ace of Cups. Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. Swords. King of Swords. Four of Swords. You make this person feel... Ooh, we like that. So this person sees you as somebody that is very, very serious. And that you might emotionally... Well, you're like extremely intelligent and you're very disciplined and you're analytical. You have a lot of deep thoughts, but you might appear very standoffish to this person. And like you get the last word because you're not tolerated. The King of Swords doesn't tolerate shit. And feelings, you're making this person feel restless. So what do they want to do? Because it's like, I want to do something. I want to do something. But with the moon energy here, they're too much of a candy ass. Why the King of Coins for action? They're not doing nothing. They're afraid to. You got this person so paranoid. Ooh, baby. How do you see them? Hangman. Knight of Wands. You're like, you're never going to be offering what I'm actually looking for. So I'm going to stay on the serious side. Because I just feel like I would end up resenting you. And you know what? I just feel like you're looking for attention sexually, and that ain't going to happen here. Majorly not going to happen. This would be like major, major stalemate between you and this person. They're kind of going, but I want something long term. And you're going, I ain't buying your shit. And you leave them going, I have no idea, but I'm restless. I want to do something. And they feel like you're leaving them in the dark. If this is the ex, they basically, they're trying to be more responsible, more this, more that. But they feel like you're, again, keeping them in the dark. And they are extremely anxious. But they feel like the answer is no. And how they see you? Pissy. Not in the mood for bullshit. For damn sure. And they feel like that you have shut down emotionally. That you just are pulling way back. And just keeping to yourself. Like you're thinking and... not trusting. You're just kind of being aside from them. How do you feel about the ex? Five of Cups. I miss you, but we're not good together. And the Ace of Wands reversed. You just don't see that this is ever going to grow. Or you lost the spark in this connection. Or feel like there's things that aren't compatible. They also might have a problem getting their hoo-ha up. And it does look like you're going, there's better things out there for me. And I'm going a different direction. So I don't feel like this person, you're leaving them in the dark. And you're basically calling them out as just kind of a can't park their ass and never commits. Ugh. But you really got that person in a tailspin. Like they have no idea what the hell you're thinking. Maybe they need a little message going, please go away. Because they get the wrong idea, Pisces, Cancer. And they do. This is like, I'm so anxious. I don't know what to do. And I'm confused, but I desire. And nobody cares. You don't. All right, Pisces, Cancer. Capricorn. Virgo, Cancer. Scorpio, Aries. Sagittarius. But all signs are in there. All right, Scorpios, that's what we have for you, and on we go. Sagittarius, if you are dealing with another Sagittarius, Aries, or a Leo, source. How do they see? All right. Okay. Well, this person sees you as somebody that's respectable, respecting, and then they feel like you would see them for who they truly are and that they could be happy with you. They want to succeed. Their action, we got the Emperor. Ooh. How do you see this person? All right. You desire this person. You would like them to put the moves on you, but you're not so sure because you got the High Priestess and the Magician. I mean, it's a good combination. I would like to, it's like, I need to be in control over this because if this is a new lover, then I need to hold back until I know more because I feel like they're kind of keeping secrets. And it's like, this person's like I use the analogy of an onion where you feel like you have to kind of peel layers to get to know this person, but that's like, I want to go for this. All right, if it's an ex, you ain't happy at all. This is looking like it's a big never happening. Don't talk to me. Don't want to hear your voice ever again. Please go the fuck away. This is how you're feeling. I feel hurt. I feel jaded. I don't want to talk to you. I don't want to see you. I feel that, I mean, your energy is like, I feel abandoned. I feel like you ghosted me. I feel like things would never be the same. That's a big fat no. We're not even going to bother with that. All right, back to singles. Feelings. Ooh, new love. So it does seem like you would definitely like to try to peel the onion open and find more out about this person. This looks nice. I would say that they are definitely going to be serious and forthcoming, stable, which is nice. All you need in there is a little Empress action. And this is, they see you as somebody that's reliable and keeps your word, and they know what to expect from you. And I feel like this is the type of person that would make me happy, but they are making it difficult. The Emperor is not the most savvy when it comes to love. He's very sturdy and responsible and reliable, and you know what to expect, but can sometimes take a bit to get this person to open up. And that's why they're seeming a little more secretive, or that they're kind of on the quiet side. All right. Next, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. All right, the Hanged Man, the Knight of, gotta have this stuff right now for feelings, and the Four of Cups. This person thinks that you are avoiding them and saying ta-ta, bye-bye. Ah, if this is the ex, they see you waiting, and they're being, they feel like, fuck this. One more. They have the idea that you still have the hots for them. Really? Your energy. All right. You feel like you got gypped. And you feel like this person possibly puts you in a third party, because that can definitely be. But this seems like somebody that said to you, I want my freedom. I want to be single. And you weren't accepting it. You're kind of like, but I know you better than you even know yourself. But the moon energy here reversed. There's still unspoken words, hidden emotions, and a very difficult talk that needs to happen. And they're like, I know you're interested. I don't care. I got to go. I'm not interested in this. I got to go. I'm out. I'm gone. I'm history. Ay, vey. If it's somebody new, oh, they would like to explore to see if the two of you, I mean, you got to, do you feel the same way I feel? I feel like this could go somewhere, and I would like to see it reciprocated, but I do have feelings for you. And it's like they're fantasizing about the connection and where things can go and hoping that it's reciprocated, but they see you as an ideal mate. So how do you see this person? Single, single, single. All right, you want to start with the friend zone, but look at that. You see, you're feeling the same way. It's like, I'm not just going to pour it out. I'm going to weigh the pros and cons here. I need to get to know you first. So it's like, you take it slow, but you see each other the same way. This is like power couple. Nice. Not if you're, you know, looking for the ex. They don't want to deal with it. And they do. They see you as waiting. Don't let that person see you waiting, even if you are waiting, because it's not going to happen. Cut of the deck. Bad outcome. They might get their karma. They might end up having to face the music, but it's not going to be what you want. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Three of Cups reversed. Seven of Pentacles. And the Ace of Swords reversed. Okay, this person's just like, done. They're like, they feel like this is a missed opportunity. They don't feel like you feel the same about them. They feel, they, as far as their action, they're not doing anything. They would be lying if they did. This is somebody that's taking like major three steps back. How they see you, like, we are never, ever, ever, ever getting back together. So you don't want to talk to them. And they have what? They feel what? Oh, they still want you. But this can, because this is a seven of coins, so that's kind of assessing the situation. Would they take me back? If they see you basically giving them the middle finger, how do you see this person? A sneaky, slimy snake? You're like, uh-uh. This, I didn't expect the bullshit that you pulled, but you avoid confrontation, you took off, you snuck off and screwed around, or whatever that, one more. You do not trust them. You're like, you, dear sir or ma'am, need to get your shit together, because any efforts that you could have had, you don't. Blockage. One more. Okay, this is somebody that needs to learn how to bite their damn tongue and stick up for the connection, whether there was another person trying to stick their nose in it. Because they make you, it's like, uh-uh. They make you feel like they're not really putting any work into it. Or that they wouldn't stick up for your connection. And you're tired of it. It's like, I'm sick of being vulnerable to somebody that needs to get their shit together. And they owe me an apology. And not happening. And I would say that they probably sense that. And this could be you. It's like their action. They might try to come in and talk to you. And you're going, single. Single. All right. Singles. All right. Opening up communication. Definitely sexually interested. They might think you're a little easy. We don't like that. How you see them. Oh, all kinds of lusty. But making it really difficult to try to get anything off of them. Why? Because they want their freedom. You got the Eight of Swords here. This is not somebody that's ready to settle down. They don't. They just want to play. They are not looking for a relationship. Mm-mm. Playing's good. And it can be somebody online. Because that's fast communication, texting, messaging. But this person's ideas are very sexual in nature. And all they're thinking about is their pants. And I would say that they would possibly lie to you because they want their freedom. Possibly lie to you to get their way with you, and then they'd be toast. Ooh, we could make them toast. A little on the well done side. All right. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. All right. Four of Pentacles. This person sees you kind of holding back. If you are single, this is somebody who feels like the two of you are very compatible and they want to go for it. Okay, I'm flying out here. Come here. All right. So they're going to approach you in a very serious way, but they definitely want your attention. They're kind of like, you're really worth it. I have hope that we can move things forward. I would like a relationship. I'm not leading you on. It's like they're trying to go out of their way. And they're being serious about it. How do you see this person? Chariot. Okay, they could be a little bit pushy. You might want to make them wait a little bit. Because it's like determined to have an opportunity with you. And it's like I'm determined to hold off a little bit. What's the likely outcome? What's the likely outcome? Single source. Well, that looks good. So that's giving them the attention that they're looking for. And at the bottom of the deck, you have the Ten of Cups. Now, this can be a party or gathering that you meet this person at, but it can turn into a long-term connection. And I'd say you'd be going for it, too. And then you got Judgment. It's like, yes, I'm being realistic. This is an improvement in my life. This is somebody that's taking me seriously. That looks nice. If it's the X, why the four? All right, this person might see you having found out all their secrets and now holding back. This is somebody that's kind of confused on what to do. And they're very up in their head going, okay, Sagittarius does not trust me at all anymore. This is still somebody that wants to come in and talk to you. They're trying to be optimistic by, hey, we can get over this. We can get past this. How do you feel towards the ex? Not so much. Mm-mm. You're like, you're so vain. You are a show-off. Your narcissistic tendencies make me wonder why the hell you haven't been committed. You basically feel like you're calling them out as a player. You're like, you're just looking for a piece of ass, and I'm not digging that shit. Let's see what we have with a cut. And this would say that they get what they deserve. So if they treated you like you were only getting so much from them, they need to put more work into it, or you wouldn't even think about it. Because the Six of Pentacles is, you got to give to get. You have got to win me over now. Would you change your mind? Would you change your mind? Maybe. Okay, at the bottom of the deck, we have the Lover's card. So maybe. But they have got to put more work into it. That's a cut. So that was in the middle of the deck. I just moved it. But seeing that this person could still be the right one for you, but they got to learn how to play ball the right way. In other words, you appreciate me. You make it worth my time. I want you to act like this connection can grow. I want you to turn away from somebody that might try to flirt with you. I want you to put work into it. Don't be a fucking sloth. It's almost like I'm waiting. Get your shit together. And I'm determined to wait until you do. But that doesn't mean that you're waiting for them. And right now, they feel like you are really just closed off. So, yeah, they'll try to talk to you and try to get you to see their point of view. Whether they're realistic or not, they still see that the two of you could try to work things out. But, boy, you are going to be on them like stink on shit. All right, let's see what we got here. Cancer. Pisces, Cancer, Capricorn, Gemini, Sassy, Justice, we have Libra, Pisces, Cancer, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Leo, heavily. Oof, that first one, I almost feel bad for them if they even tried to come your direction. I think you might scalp them at dawn. All right, Sagittarius, that's what we have for you, and on we go. Capulets, if you are dealing with an Aries, Leo, or Sag, how do they see you? All right. Feelings. Okay, two came out. And action. Okay. So this person thinks that they're coming back home to mama. Mm-hmm. But there seems to be a little bit of you saying, bullshit if you are. Okay, this person feels like you do not trust them, you don't want to deal with them, but they're like, I'm going to try anyway. How they see you, possibly talking to other people, and one more. Oh, the fucking door, did you move in with a friend? I mean, oh my God, it's like, I'm out. Smooth sailing for me. Sorry, you're having problems. And this could be financial issues, and they're kind of like, no, I need to, it's almost like there's like, property that this person thinks that they can invade on, and you're going, fuck if you are, but I can make everything all better. We can heal this. Won't you forgive me? Really? What's their damage? Okay, so we have somebody that doesn't always know when to tell the truth, acts like the fucking victim, and then we flip this one. And isn't over you, but they aren't looking to try to improve the situation. This is like you got Al Bundy laying on your fucking couch being a lazy sloth or non-committal. How do you feel? No. It's like, piss off, no. No, I'm staying with the divorce, the separation, whatever that is. It's like, you can't change my opinion of you. You screwed up royally. You got judgment reversed here. So, no chance, not happening, no go. All right, if this is somebody new, no, this person's not over their ex. Run. Because at the bottom of the deck, you have this person's going to be stubborn. They're too much feeling sorry for themselves, and they will put you in the friend zone. Cut of the deck, they're trying to knock on their... You keep on knocking, but you can't commit. They're looking to try to improve the status that they are in with the ex, and they're frustrated. So let them be frustrated by themselves, because here you're saying, I'm looking for something fun that has a potential to grow and go somewhere. And I don't think that you are it. No, you don't think they're it. You're like, take your fucking ass elsewhere, you arrogant asshole. So you got Al Bundy that's lazy and his hand in his pants with his gut hanging out thinking, you bitch, get me a beer. No, not happening. You're like, no, you're too lazy. You're not coming back. But they have this idea that they should be able to. I'm coming back around. You left. You left. That means the door is shut. All right. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Oh, boy. How this person sees you. Their feelings and their action. Okay. I'm feeling like this person wants you to let go because they might want their freedom. So let go of me. They don't know what the hell they want. This person's got a roaming eye. Okay, how they see you? Possibly naive, really? One more. Like they got one over on you? Oh, that is what they think. Holy shit sticks. And they're like, no, there's not any drama here going on. I'm not worried about it. There ain't going to be any arguments and conflict. But I want my freedom. Well, then fucking go. Do you feel like you can still have this person's attention and then that would go anywhere? Because it's like you almost anticipate. Look at that. You're going to pay attention to me. You're going to fucking act like an intelligent person. You're going to have more patience. You're going to be more committed. Are you smoking weed? What is their damage? Okay. This person thinks that they're always in charge. They're irritable. They don't want a commitment. I do not want. Don't want. Their insecurities, that's not somebody that wants to... Why would you want this person? Why would you want to give them a second chance? I want to be fair. They're not interested. And they might have already told you that they're not interested. This can make you feel depressed about this person and possibly that they're going through with proceedings or separation or whatever the hell it is. And it's like, I wanted harmony. But they're not giving you what you want. If you want this person back, it's a big no. Cut of the deck. There's no hope in it. A missed opportunity. It's got you anxious. You really want this person back? They're a headache. They're a headache. Singles. All right. This person would be a little guarded, really fucking closed off, and not too sure about committing. How you see them? You see them moving extremely slow, but definitely wanting your attention. So it's like, okay, attention you shall have. But they could be seeing you this way too. A little bit protecting yourself, a little bit guarded, and definitely demanding, I will be valued. I will be treated well. And yeah, it does look like they would like to. So new person, yes. Ex, fuck. Why would you even consider it? It's like you've lost your crazy marbles. They fell out like my dad's. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. All right. This person sees you as the boss and in charge, and they're determined. That's nice, but are you a conquest? This feels to me like this person's confused about what the hell to do. Like they can't make up their mind. Why? No, really? Why the Emperor for how they see you? They feel like you need to... They feel like you're not doing nothing and you're not sticking up for this connection and you're just sitting there going, I'm loyal, I'm responsible, and I'm staying right the hell where I am. One more for feelings. Feelings. They feel like you do not care about them anymore and that you're trying to actually get over them. They're all confused. About what? About what? Because I'm starting over. I have this idea. No, it ain't gonna work. They have an idea. They have a big happy heart on, but they can't figure out what the hell they want. And this is somebody that basically looks like they put you in a third party. What's their damage? All right. Did you have to play arts and crafts with this person? Because it's looking like... Let's flip these. You were trying to be optimistic that this person wasn't just going to be a player, that they would actually get their shit together if you were just a little bit more tolerant, and you waited and you waited and you waited, and they disappointed you. It's like they're careless, they're a show-off, they send mixed signals, and it's like, I've been patient, I've been optimistic, and they're not giving you what you want. They're a piss-off, too. Holy crap, what the hell? Ooh. Likely outcome if it's an ex. All right, no, because you need to care more about yourself than you do that person. It's time to let it go. It's time to walk away. It's almost like source telling you, you've done everything that you could to try to make a difference in this connection. And it's just, whatever choice has been made, you're better off leaving it. Because the deadlock, the stalemate between you and this person needs to stop. Singles. All right, you got the sun. And the world, and it's better. All right, so give it a little bit of time. It does look like you might already have your eye on somebody with the magician at the bottom of the deck. It's like, ooh, I'm definitely desiring somebody. It does look like it's just a matter of time. There could be a physical distance, especially with the world and the three of wands. But this is somebody that can, you know, you'd see them as somebody worthwhile to start things up with. But there could be a little bit of a wait as far as making things move forward. It's like nice energy. The effort is there, but you're going to have to wait it out a little bit. But it's something to look forward to. All right. It's better than that other crap. Okay. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Six of Pentacles, Three of Cups. And the Four of Cups. Person's being quiet. It's almost like they feel that if they tried to tell you that they were going to be more responsible, you'd be like, yeah, right. How they see you, they're hoping to get a second chance. It's like, okay, if I give to get, would you be willing to try? They feel like the two of you should be together. If this is singles, might be a little bit too quick to jump in the sack. Just saying, because it looks like you're going, ah, da-da-da-da-da-da, I control my zipper just fine. One more for the six. Okay, so they see you trying to determine if you're going to give them more time or give them a second chance, or do they deserve it or not. So they see this could be a connection with the ex that's been on and off and back and forth, and you've been together, then you're not, and then you're together, and this is looking like this person's like, they're throwing a little fit. I'm not interested in things happening the way you want them to happen. They don't what? They don't want to be ambitious? One more for the ex's horseshit. They give up way too easy. And then they cross their arms and act like a stubborn little brat. No, it didn't work out my way, so I don't want it anymore. Wow. Really? Because with the four there? Fine. I'm not interested anymore. What that? That's child's horse shit. Singles. No. 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 This is not somebody that no. They would struggle to be able to offer you anything. They're careless. They need to improve their efforts. And they're in a major stubborn energy, feeling sorry for themselves. And the most you'd get out of them is friend-zoning bullshit. Let's see what you think. Yeah, maybe they just need to not talk to me. Go take your break. Get over your shit in life. Yeah, you don't trust it. You got the devil reversed. I'm giving up on things that are tempting but no good for me. And there's too many red flags here. Oh my God, you guys just got slammed with crap. Ouch. Not today, boy. All right, let's go through the majors. Taurus. Leo. Aries, Pisces, Cancer. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Gemini. You blame the Wookiee. Put it in comments. Wookiee, you dealt us shit because he mixed the deck. Ha ha ha. Scorpio. But obviously there is a reason for everything. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, heavy Leo again. Pisces, Sagittarius. Cancer and Aries. All right, my Capulets, that's what we sadly have for you. And on we go. Aquarius. All right, if you're dealing with an Aries, Leo, or Sag, what does this person see, Aquarius? Oh, okay. Well, we got a good idea on who this is. All right. Feelings. All right, two flew out. So this person's feeling optimistic that the two of you can heal the situation. Action. All right, they're restless. They want to talk. They don't feel like things are done between the two of you, and they're going to come at you in a cutesy little flirty way. I'd say you're interested. I still have feelings for you. However, your attitude has got to stop. This person could have addiction issues. They also could have issues keeping their zipper up. But it does look like you still feel like this is the right person for you. The communication might suck ass, but this person goes to extremes. And we'll see here. All right, one more for the Six of Cups for how they see you. All right. They see you accepting an apology so that the two of you can be all nostalgic and get comfy cozy again. They feel like you should be more optimistic because we can heal things. How do you see this person? All right. Okay. You feel like it's too quick. It's like, I don't know if I can do this if it's this quick. The bottom of the deck. You're not willing to just risk it. You're kind of like, I don't know if I want to take a chance at this. And this person seems like they're going to be a little on the pushy. And you're like, I'm worried about just jumping into something. What's the likely outcome if it's an ex? End up single. Too many secrets. Okay, I just don't feel like you trust this person. I don't know why you would want them back. Now, if you are single, this is looking like somebody that might still, how they see you, possibly wanting your ex back. It also can be somebody that, no, they think you want to go back to your ex. And they feel like you are trying to be optimistic about trying to go back to your ex. Their energy is going, why bother? Because this is just going to be like you're looking for attention and have no other intentions. You're just looking for attention. And they're just like, they see, you're worried about, no, you're just too up in your head. You're going to end up by yourself because this person has no idea what the hell you want. And they think you're stuck on your ex. All right. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay. All right. And action. Okay. Now, if you were single, this person's very curious and a little bit intimidated. They see you kind of like, I want the truth, nothing but the truth, so help you, God. And they're like, I want a new opportunity. And you're kind of going, it's going slow. It has to go slow. Or it also could be that it's too slow. Let's get a little more clarity. Now, it seems like there's not necessarily an argument, but somebody kind of thinks that they can just come and go. That ain't so cool. Uh-uh. That can be the ex as well. More for singles with the world energy. All right. Now, I just... Now, this can be one hell of a sexual connection that it just throws you completely out of whack. Like, did not expect to see that coming and a new opportunity. So, how do you feel towards this newer person? Okay. All right, there could be an age difference, but you do see them and feel about them that they could make you happy. They might be kind of like a hard nut to crack, as in trying to get to know them, and they're a little bit on the introverted side. Very smart, very wise. Does this move forward? All right. It looks like it has potential, but you both have to trust. Bottom of the deck, you have the Three of Wands. So if you are single, this does look like somebody that you would be content with, happy, and successful. But you might need to, it's like the sex is off the charts, don't get me wrong. But there's a feeling of this person being intimidated and you kind of going, I want this. And they're a little bit more laid back on, don't press for this to go anywhere too fast. Holding back a little bit. And you're kind of going, but I want this to move forward. Okay, it's worth the wait. Fine, okay, fine, you win. If this is the ex, they see you as possibly cutting them out. This is somebody that you feel that they're acting, because this is their feelings. They feel insecure. They feel like you know what they've been up to, that they feel defensive. And with the Ace of Cups, why the Ace of Cups? Okay, that they want you back. You got the Nine of Cups and the Ace, that equals 10. That is, I want my connection back, but I'm anxious about whether or not Aquarius would give me the time of day. This is somebody that is possibly needing to learn a lesson. You still, it's like, do you see it now, person? Do you see the light? Can you see that you put me in a position where I wonder what's going to happen with our future? What is their damage? Okay. You're a fucking large child. They're very good at getting what they want, but then what happens? So I come in and I apologize. It seems like this has been this person's MO. Like you know what to expect from them. I come in, I apologize, I tell you that I'm going to put more work into it, and then what happens? Oh, you know, I accidentally flirted with somebody and fell into a vagina. Not so good. This is somebody that's self-absorbed. And they could piss you off. This person also could have one hell of a temper if they don't get what they want. Likely outcome if it's an ex. No. Cut them loose. Cut them loose. It's time to let go. Try to look forward, not back. This is like you're at a crossroads with this person. And it does not seem like you are ever going to get what you want with them. Like it's not possible, or they avoid you, or they constantly make you feel jealous, or they're just wasting your fucking time. But there's no progress with this person. They're not offering what your needs are. Ooh, cut of the deck, it came out again. Two of Wands. You really need to think about this decision. So whatever you're planning on doing, work on you first. This would be like a little bit of healing, because do you really, it's like it's too fresh, it's too new. You need to give this a little bit more time to think about it. Because can you trust this person or not? And they might be going tick, tick, you know, no, don't be push, push. Chill, chill. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. All right. Well, that's a nice beginning. All right, newbie. If you have a new love coming your direction, this means get the hell out of the house. It does look like something that you would want to see grow. Can be a Libra or a Taurus. But this is somebody that sees you as an opportunity. They're going, this person, they're trying to be realistic. They see you as somebody that is important. They see that you would be an improvement in their life. This is somebody that wants a new beginning, and they want you to see the light. This person feels like you're a big change, possibly from their usual, but they want progress. They're like, I want this new beginning, and this can be that they're offering something long term. It also can be that their plans are to go out to get to know you, so you meet, and this person sees you kind of as a mystery, kind of like, I like the analogy, I've used it a lot of times, but of an onion. You're sexy, you're seductive, but you're also mysterious. And it's like, how do I get a chance with this person? How do you see this new person? Ooh. Okay. It does, I'm getting that you need to go out. With the cuts, you've got the Ten of Cups, you got the Ten of Pentacles here. Go out. If you want a new opportunity, this is celebration. It's also freedom. So using your intuition about somebody new, it's not exploiting yourself to a new connection, but thinking about it. And it's like, where could this go? I might be able to fall for this person. It does look like you would be a little bit impressed by them. Let's move forward. Really quick. So yeah, I would say that both of you want an opportunity, and they want the opportunity, but you need to give them the chance. You need to open up a little bit is what I am feeling here. And I do see another date. After having meet this person, you have a chit chat and more dates. So go for it. If this is the ex, it seems like they have a secret hoe on the outside of the home. Mm-hmm. This would tell me that you still have feelings for them. They see you as possibly forgiving. So be very cautious, because this might be somebody that you're in a rush to have them back. They're likely out to come. Not risking it. I do feel like this person's going to try to reach out, tell you what you want to hear. Because this would be like, I'm telling you what you want to hear. I am confessing my emotions, and this is what the truth is. But are you going to outsmart their ass? Are you used to hearing the same story? Let's get one. No, you're not interested in the same old dance. You're like, I don't want to hear it. I got a little bit of Ozzy Osbourne going on there for a second. Not interested. I refuse to accept your lines and bullshit. I've heard it all before. And this would say that you're doing what's best for yourself. So calling them out. It's like, you know what? You want a resolution, then you got to take the consequences too. Because if this person's on outs with you, where are they? This would say it's a secret. Well, I'm ranting their ass out, because it's not a secret. I think you'd have a pretty damn good idea where they are. And it does look like they abandoned you, left you out in the cold. And then they think they can come back and hang out on your couch until you're comfortable with them in the bed. Be careful. Because this seems like somebody went across the street and the grass wasn't so green on the other side. Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Ooh, there's that Empress. So this person sees you as somebody that they want. They feel like you would be in a major improvement. They want to communicate with you. And they're coming at you slow, though. So, in a very respectable way. How do you see this person? Okay. Good looking. Maybe a little forward. But it's like somebody that wants to be successful. They want to win. Ooh. And again, with the feeling of get the hell out of the house. Because, like I said, the Ten of Cups can be family, friends. But it can be parties and celebrations. So singles looking good. If it's the ex, what are they going to do? They're going to try to pour on the swoon bullshit. What's the blockage? Ooh, they're a manipulative, narcissistic asshole. And they aren't open emotionally. This is somebody that it's just money, money, money. They're obsessively, it's almost like you're a possession compared to actually caring about you. How do you see this person? Moody as hell. I would be careful with this one, because this is kind of like they say one thing and then they get you all frustrated because their feelings aren't stable. Can be somebody that overdrinks, overscrews, and you just feel like things just don't work. They say they're going to do one thing and then the whole shit blows up. It's like, I'm trying to trust you, but I can't because you make it too hard. Temperance reverse is like things should be, they're not healthy. They're not balanced. This person takes the wrong approach and their feelings are unstable. They blow shit way out of proportion and you just feel like you could have felt neglected too, but you just feel like things were not working between the two of them. I don't like the ex can, but they're still going to try. All right, let's see what we have for majors. Heavy Sagittarius. Pisces, Cancer, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Libra, Aries, Pisces, Leo, Virgo, Scorpio, Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Scorpio again, Pisces, And Cancer. All right, my Aquariuses, that's what we have for you. And we go. Pisces, how you bees? All right, you're dealing with an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius. This person sees you, feelings. All right, and their action. Two of Coins, Two of Cups. Why the Five of Wands reversed? Oh, they want to kiss and make up, do they? So they see you as possibly a little bit not trusting, a little bit huffy. And basically, you'll tell it like it is. Look at that. This person sees you kind of being like, I don't fucking trust you. I don't know if I want to even deal with your ass, that you're being cold, standoffish, and that you would tell it like it is. Like they have the idea that you are being very, like you don't want to talk to them, like you're putting them off, like you're basically giving them, it's like you need some time to think about the shit that you put me through type thing, and they know it. So their actions, kind of like going back and forth, can try to get your attention and make things work. How do you see this person? Shit, I got my closure. I want to be single, or you wanted to be single, but I don't have the same feelings about you anymore. Mm-mm. You're not pushing the fucking tower back up. Nope. You feel like this person's in denial, that they're irrational, that they're trying to avoid an ending between the two of you, and you're kind of going, wow. You know, I'm dodging the bullet and you're avoiding the reality. If it's somebody single. No. Look at this. They still want to go back to their ex and they're worried that they might not be accepted. So what? So you'd be a fucking option? If their ex took them back, you would be dumped. No. They can fuck off. Okay. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Ooh, this person sees you as somebody they want to get busy with. All right. Move that all the way. Feelings. Ooh, give me a chance. So, they are coming at you with I kind of like it, approach, because they're going, okay, this can be somebody that you know, it's like, I have my freedom. Are you single? Are you available? I know I really got to come at you, right? But this person sees you as like the life of the party and lots of fun, and they want an opportunity, but they want you to take them seriously. Why so serious? Because they have in their mind that you have a lot to offer and that this could turn into love. How do you see them? Ten of Coins. Ooh. So it's like, I'll take a chance with this person. Now, the Ten of Coins also can be for singles, because we're saying singles here. A gathering, a party, a get-together, can be family-orientated, and it might be just something absolutely where there's just groups of people. But with the Fool energy, you're like, this is worth taking a chance. How does this move forward? So give this person the opportunity. It looks like they sure the hell have a lot to offer. You wouldn't see it obviously right away, but if you're objective, give this person. It's like you're going to be looking for the facts. I want to know where you're coming from. I want respect. It's a strong character, and you might test him a little bit. So nothing wrong with that. Okay, and nice outcome. So taking it slow, not in any rush. However, giving this person the opportunity to reciprocate. I think that you want to start on the, hey, I want to get to know you better. I want to know more about you. I'm not in any rush, holding back a little bit here, but there's a lot of passion. The passion's real. But they know they have to take you seriously. The King of Wands, it's like they see you as somebody that whatever you want, you get. I like it. Now, if it is the ex, why judgment? They still love you. So they're going to try and come at you. We can be back together again. Your energy towards the ex. Seven of, I don't fucking know about this. That's what you're saying. You're not so sure you would possibly forgive this person. It seems like there was a big secret that was out in the dark. And Ten of Wands, you're having a hard time thinking that this person's going to change. What's the likely outcome if you gave this person a second chance? Seven of Cups reversed, not bad. There's still hope. There is actually still hope because now it's like, I see you for who you truly are, not treating you like an option. So if they have been playing footsie with somebody else, they've made up their mind. It's like the icing's off the cake. I'm being realistic. I see you for who you are. I still have feelings. This is like daydreaming. And yeah, this is like a go for it. And with the Seven of Coins, it's like, I'm still kind of on the fence about you, so you're going to have to really show me that you mean it. But this does look like it could work. And they do love. Ew. I get hives when I say love. Ew. All right. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Ooh, the Magician. So they're looking at you with desire. How they feel towards you. I feel like you're down to earth. This is somebody that sees you as not picky, not like you don't have to have fashion bags, and you're very, not Versace, that you're very a hard worker and down to earth. All right. And they feel like this could be a connection that would be stable. So they're going, I'm taking the high ground here, and I will wait it out if I have to. It's like, I'm willing to fight for this. I mean, they see you as a catch, a big catch. So it's like, you're going to be my new lover. How do you see this person that has decided for you? Ooh, it's good luck having met this person. Ooh, look at this. So you got a power couple here to begin with. And the Ace of Swords, it's like it's a breakthrough. You finally meet somebody that's not a bonehead and has their head up their ass. Cut of the deck, you have the Ace of Coins. It's a new beginning. So it's like, okay, let's come to terms with where this could go. But starting slow. Not in a hurry. Ooh, bottom of the deck, you have Temperance. So definitely intimacy, Netflix chill, seeing how the two of you balance. And I'd say that you feel like this is a good opportunity and that this person could be very similar to you. I mean, they're looking at you that way. You're looking at them this way. Hello, lover. Come to mama. And they think you got it all going on with the Magician there. All right. We like Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Taurus, the Sun. All right. The Moon for feelings. Action. Eight of Wands. Let's talk. Why the Moon for feelings? This person really wants to be happy, but they feel like they're in the dark. Poor baby them. So, single. All right. This is somebody that you would like to see work out. You can see that this person would be very dedicated, but you could get, this person might be a little on the jealous side or a little bit on the obsessive side. So I would say slow, slow. How does this move forward? Ooh, the Chariot and Three of Coins. It does look like the two of you would be on the same page. This is on the same page, and this is determination. The Chariot is movement. Like, I want to move it, move it. It's pushing forward. It's having confidence. It's like overcoming any issues and being optimistic and accomplishing the goal of working together and building something. I like it. If it's the ex. Oh, they miss you. They want to talk. Oh, they see you, Two of Swords, not changing your mind. They feel like the two of you have a stalemate. They feel like there's still happiness here, but it's their happiness because they don't have a fucking clue how you feel. So how do you feel? I'm walking away from you. You can kiss my living ass. And then you're worried. If you give this person an opportunity, you feel like it would end up being the same thing. Bottom of the deck, you got the Lovers reversed. the communication sucks ass to begin with, but are you codependent on this person? Just be on the careful side, because there's indecision written all over this. No trust, confusion, not sure how I feel anymore. What's the likely outcome with the X? The X. Four coins. That's holding back. Page. Okay. So they're going to reach out. And if there's any obsession involved here, it's going to be theirs. Wanting to try to hold on. Trying to work things out. That also is a I miss you. There's the I want to come back. Well, we knew it was coming eventually. Here's an apology. Here's an apology. I miss you. I miss you. I miss you. I feel I have fucked up. Well, yes, you have. You have fucked up. But this is somebody that's like, I want to make things work. It does look like they are obsessed with trying to make things work, but you might tell them to piss up a rope. They do feel that you're kind of going, I don't see that you make me happy anymore, or I don't see that you're going to, like, one partner may have more needs for attention than the other, or there's pressure to play the supporting role, or, like, you have to pound sunshine up their ass for them to be happy. It's like, let's get clear on this shit right off the bat. I am not going to try to kiss your ass and make you happy. So, I mean, there is definitely some clarity, because especially with the moon here, it's like, they have no idea how you feel. I'd be happy, but I don't really, what, they don't fucking get you? Then why would they want to be, I miss you so much, I just could burst. Well, then spontaneously combust and get your shit together. Collect yourself after you blow up. Get it together. All right. Ah, shit, I just grabbed the whole deck. All right, Aries, at least I know where I was. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius, Aquarius. Libra, Leo, Aries. That's the silliest thing I've done today. All right. Taurus, Leo, Scorpio, Aquarius. Taurus, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. That is where we end. Pisces, Cancer. All right, my cupcakes. That's what we have for you. Thanks for watching. Many blessings, and hope to see you next time.